No, I need to do a reset of my world going around and reshare here. Just a second.
There are people listening from every corner of this planet. No knowledge has been dispersed so beautifully, so balanced across the planet, on this planet ever, maybe in the universe. You have the full potential of achieving everything in the universe. There is no need and there is no reason for man not to achieve. So, wherever you are, the way I taught you to make the coils double coil inside, you have continuous eco gravitational magnetic field, and if you put CO2 on it, and you put zinc on it, you have connected the emotion of the man to it by the stable condition, and you'll find out you become a very peaceful man. Here, instead of having galaxies and universes and creating connection magnetically, we have used the matter state gravitational magnetic field strength to dominate and dictate the shape of the plasma. The nano technology, the nanomaterial which you have collectively developed in different ways, by caustic, by electric currents, by whatever, fire or whatever, has that advantage that the matter, the nano and the plasma is all the same. So connection is very solid, it's very strong. The power of the plasma technology, the way we have thought, is beyond imagination of the mind. Now you can create and control the plasma, which is the mother of the creation of the universe. You are given the seed of the essence of the creation. The foundation does not belong to no one and is not made of one anymore. You are developing it, you are structuring it, and from today, we will be still the same. We'll still develop the technology in different names, in different colors, in different nationalities, which they do not exist. It is beautiful when we see the Christian, the Muslims, the Jews, and every other belief are working together to build up systems. We have already become one faith. We already have become one nation, and we already become one planet. You got to remember one thing. Dates is irrelevant. Today is the last day of the Christian calendar, or tomorrow is the beginning of another. One day is connected to another. We don't stop. We are working round the clock. The Keshe Foundation team is working irrespective of time, position, religion, country. And now we achieve what we set out for.
The Universal Council invites you to attend the One Planet, One Nation, One Race event in Rome on the 9th and 10th of September 2016. The Council looks forward to open interaction with the public at the event. Come interact with the Council in your spoken language. The Council encourages you to bring your positive suggestions and solutions to the table on how humanity can move forward as a whole towards everlasting peace. In this way, the work of the members of the Council will become the work of humanity for humanity. The full package price for a single ticket to the event includes 3-night stay in one of Rome's prestigious hotels, daily attendance to the event, as well as breakfast on the 9th through the 11th, and lunch and tea on the 9th and 10th. Accommodations for this package is based on double occupancy. The full package price for 2 tickets to the event includes 3-night stay in a twin bed room in one of Rome's prestigious hotels, daily attendance to the event, as well as breakfast on the 9th through the 11th, and lunch and tea on the 9th and 10th. Additional night stay are offered at €150 per person per night. For those who wish to arrange their own accommodations and who plan on attending a single day of the event, the cost will be €200, which includes tea and lunch on the day of the event. For those who wish to arrange their own accommodations and who plan on attending both days of the event, the cost will be €400, which includes tea and lunch on the day of the event. The One Planet, One Nation, One Race event in Rome. Come share your positive solutions on how we can work together to bring everlasting peace to our world. Would you like to be one of the first humans in space using plasma technology? The Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute is now taking applications for the Man-Originated Zone Habitation and Nutrition Training Program, or MOZON. The goal of MOZON is to teach trainees how to create and utilize the magnetically oriented joint habitation and nutrition system that will be used for life in space. Be one of the first humans in space using plasma technology. The 3-month MOZON training program begins in the fall of 2016. Apply today at mozon.kfssi.org. Trainees will be taught every aspect of plasma technology needed for them to go to space and survive, and will be educated in space ethos. Participants are expected to bring the knowledge forward to the peoples of their nations to prepare them to become peoples of space. Matter propulsion technology. Today on Earth, we use inefficient and costly rocket propulsion technology, which burns fuels to overcome the magnetic gravitational fields of the planet to go to space. We power our rockets, our cars, and our homes by burning matter to release the energy that we convert from one form to another in order to create motion and usable energy. As well, to achieve objectives, rockets, for example, have to carry large and heavy payloads of fuel, which means that they're payload dependent. Matter propulsion technology is very destructive, inefficient, polluting, and wasteful. Now, let's look at the new alternative, matter gravitational technology. Matter gravitational technology uses the properties of the entirety of plasma to create motion, lift, and energy without destroying the characteristics of matter. The system utilizes magnetic and gravitational field interaction to attain positioning and motion. Nothing is burned, there's no waste, and no pollution is created. Matter gravitational technology is efficient and not destructive. Current human scientific achievement is the result of a progressive evolution in science and technology over thousands of years. Plasma technology is the next step in that evolution. It's viable, and it's here today. You could be one of the first humans in space using plasma technology. Apply today to the MOZON training program.
Welcome, everyone, to the 116th Knowledge Seekers Workshop of the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute. And it's June 2nd, 2016. And as usual, we have Mr. Keshe with us, as we have for the last 115 Knowledge Seekers Workshops, as well as many more before and during that. And I think he's ready to go with today's activities. We have a few things lined up, as he will explain. And we're still trying to get a few things ready to go here, but we'll be able to accommodate. Are you ready to go there, Mr. Keshe, pretty much? Or?
Yes, good morning. Good day to you, as usual. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can, thank you.
Yeah, good day to you, as usual, as I said, wherever and whenever you listen to these teachings. First of all, before we start, you hear the voices of Rick and Vince every time here we've been, and today is the birthday of both of them. So, happy birthday to both of you, old and young men. Wish lots of happy years, and thank you for being with the Foundation for such a long time. How does it feel to be 60, Rick?
Well, it was good to feel 60. I'm actually 61 now, so it's...
Oh, you haven't
gotten... I've gotten over the shock of being 60, in spite of feeling more like 16. But it's okay. It's all okay, actually. It feels good to have made it through this far and be in the position I'm in right now. So it's amazing. World that we live in, and I'm very happy, yes.
We're not going to ask Vince because he's too sleepy to talk.
So.
The same goes to Vince. Happy birthday to you both.
He gets to turn a decade older today.
Yeah.
40s.
Right. As part of the teaching, as we said, we carry on with the development of the technology. We will carry on in teaching a new aspect, in a way increasing the technical knowledge than evolving new systems and new directions in teaching. We're getting ready for the space excursion. There are a number of systems running in the background, and we're working with a number of governments in the background with different aspects of the technology. And private, and in so many ways, as said before, it took some time for people to go from core to cores, and then going from plasma and the GANs. And now we expect when the people who understood the technology are going to come up with the new understanding of the fields. And that's strange enough. We see at the same time a number of people have understood the principle of the field plasma, and now that we see the development, we bring a new understanding of the use of the plasma in different aspects of the space technology. Deep space technology means independence from this planet. Deep space technology means knowing that wherever you go in space, you are safe, irrespective of the position, in respect to the time in life of the man, and in the respect of feel the strength across the universe. Man has evolved and been kept in a very safe nursery. We call it the planet Earth. Everything is done for us. We are protected, we are held on to, food provided, and the Mother Earth has nourished us thousands and millions of years on this planet. In a way, human race has become like a teenager who tries to go out and he can see if he can survive in the society. And this is where we are going. This is where the step of the man is to come to enter the universal community. We've been nourished, we've been looked after, we've been fed, protected, given the light, the energy, the heat and everything else which could guarantee and assure the existence of the man on this planet. This is where the spaceship changes position. Man has become a teenager, as usual, becoming 18, given the key to the house, as is tradition in the English culture, if you understand it, that now you're an adult, you can come home when you like, but as long as you do whatever you do outside and learn about the life in the society. The spaceship program is the key to a teenager who start going out. Going out into the space and knowing that there is a home if he wants to come back, but being trained enough that outside in the wild world of the space, he can survive the whole good and bad, and can come home or at least make home wherever he likes, to feel safe and be able to look after himself and his family. This has been part of the teaching of the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute, to teach how to do what you need to do and the way to do it. It's like when you have a teenager and at the age of say 18, on the birthday, you start giving him a key to a car, to be able for the teenager to start learning to drive and go out and travel around and come back home safe. You give the key, you give the car, and you give them instructor to teach them how to drive. We are in that stage. We are building the car, we've been given the car, we are given the key to the car, and now we are training from now on to teach how man to drive in the universal space, in the space of this solar system, in the space of this planet, in the space of the galaxy, and in the space of the universe. It'll take time to progress from one to another, but we have laid the foundation, the correct foundation for man to become a driver in space that can come back home safe. Or if you decide, I'm 18, I want to move out of the house and find myself a new place and become independent and see new places. We've done it for millions of years. That's how we came from one tribe to another. As we moved out further from the family, we started the cities, we started small villages, we started countries and the rest of it. Now we start the excursion into space the same way. Now it's for us to learn the rules of the conduct of the space travel. It's for us to understand where to tank fuel and which restaurant we need to stop for food to come back home. But this time the man has been given the opportunity to be able to know how not only to drive the car, but to build his own car, how to make his own food, how to make his own shelter, and as we did in '60s, we became the hippies and the campers. Now we become space people who start camping across the universe. So we need to have everything. We need to be able to produce what we need, not waiting for the next fuel station and not waiting for the next stop where we can get some water and some food. The process of the Keshe Foundation teaching, especially KFSSI, is to not in a way to enforce one path of the thinking, this is what we say, but opening different path of thinking from everyone to participate and bring their own knowledge, and collectively, as we gather knowledge together, make it easier for collectively the human race to find different ways of getting to space according to our intelligence and understanding, but giving everyone the same chance. And this is what we have achieved. We have gone across races, we've gone across what we call countries, we've gone across every possible way. We cover every country on this planet. No foundation, no organization has achieved such a penetration ever in the history of man in such a short time. It took Christ 300 years. It took Muhammad more than that. And still, because they use the belief of the man to control the soul of the man, they got bogged down. This time, it's you, the soul of you and the man who decides, and there is no limit if you conduct the ethos of the space in a correct way, not to harm, that you don't get harmed. Not to take advantage of the space in a way you done on this planet, but work within the fields and the structure of the space of the universe, and is welcoming, is nourishing, and in so many ways, we have become part of the universal space. This is what I've said many times. The behavior of the man has kept man away to enter the universal community. Now, gradually, as we see, internationally, a large number of people have taken up the ethos of the Keshe Foundation, trying to create peace amongst men, trying to create systems which makes man independent of the conditions which has brought pain and suffering to man for centuries. When we can supply all the needs of the man, then we understand the man changes his habit. The comfort of having everything, it changes the position of everything. In being able to see clearly, it changes the perception and the work. In understanding the technology that how we can survive and how we become peaceful allows man to enter the universal community. As we saw in the last video, we are preparing the last stage for man to enter into the space community. But entering into space community with a man who has been so violent for thousands of years, millions of years, is not easy. We will see reactions and we see interactions, but in time we will see the process of the healing of the man to change his habit of killing to peaceful actions. So, in totality, one by one, we have made the steps. Part of you, some of you, are developing the space technology to make the car. Some of you are developing the food part. Some of you are developing the energy side. Some of you are developing the material side. Some of you are developing the health side. So, collectively, we are working one direction. Some might look a bit strange, some might look a bit too far-fetched for the others, but it's working. Gradually, in next 3 months, 6 months, we will see millions of human race will start working that direction. We have made the ground ready. The knowledge has been spread. We see in our teachings, we come from all corners of this planet to share knowledge and freely share it. And this has never been done. We became threat to multinationals, we became threat to those who structured the world to be busy with wars that they could, what we call, take the advantages of it. And now we see, they see the Keshe Foundation, which is you lot, as a threat. In a way, they don't need us anymore. We see a number of scientific and influential groups turning towards the Foundation in a very tentative way to start working, understanding, maybe to be with us, or maybe to find a way to penetrate, to disturb the flow, that they could carry on with the behavior of the past. I'll give you one warning, that is, the knowledge is spread so much that it's no camping on either side, it's only one camp, and that's a camp of human race to go forward. We received communication from number of these organizations in different ways, and we've been accused that they have penetrated the Keshe Foundation as different ways to control it. The control of the Keshe Foundation is not in the hand of one man, one nation. is in the hand of the humanity. So, what we hear, what we see, what communications we receive, we have become impenetrable, because the people who've done their job for past centuries to control with war and economy, now they are part of the economy of the Keshe Foundation. We are touching them, but not as one place, one man, but across the planet. You are building the Magrav systems, you are building the health systems, you are building the GANS plasma systems for health, and you are thousands and millions of you across this planet. Up to now, they had a target. Now, the target is spread. They become minority, but this still the old habit will go, trying to bring control that they could have something, crumbs from this cake. But this cake is intact. This cake is intact as a human race, going forward with what we see as peace, as beginning of a beautiful relationship between man among themselves in sharing knowledge, but at the same time, not having those who would like to be as leaders, as they call themselves. We all are equal in sharing knowledge, and we share it beautifully. And more of you establishing different approaches and paths and avenues into the Keshe Foundation, the stronger we become. Diversity is the strength of the Keshe Foundation. Diversity in knowledge, sharing knowledge, and the way we have grown and are growing across the planet has become our strength. We are on the verge of man into travel into space, on the principle of the space, what we call technical knowledge, work of the universe, and without damaging the universe condition. But as I said, in the coming time, very soon, once we achieve a given numbers, those given numbers, including the governments who have part of the technology but not the full, will be given access to universal community. We know we can mention nation by nation, which have made contact approaches and have been trying for past few decades at least to develop the space technology, which they have been given to, but due to their conduct have been withheld from the final keys. The final keys will be given in mass that no nation and no country will be any different. In our travel into China, with the help of the Chinese government and the support of Keshe Foundation, we will open the space technology with the leadership of President Xi. That the nation stays peaceful, the man become peaceful. This is a gift from us to humanity. In so many ways, we look into the other world leaders to join, step by step. But we have now collectively to add to the knowledge of man that we have given you the tools, you need to learn the methods. You need to understand more and more. I step down, gradually my teachings will come to an end, because I created a condition for you, the knowledge seekers and the teachers of the knowledge seekers, and in every language you start teaching. We have reached that, what we call the watershed. We've seen the Italians start teaching themselves, the Germans, the French, the Spanish, the Chinese, the Japanese, and you name it, you are doing it. So, my job as a teacher is more or less coming to an end. I step down very soon. In the coming time, when I make man ready for a space, and when we put the man face to face with what I call the creatures of the space, that we create a friendship handshake across the humanity with the universal community, I step down, because I achieved my goal. But in that process, we have to understand one thing. We have to change our ethos of war and warmongering and destroying to achieve to have. In next 3 months or 6 months, we will achieve this. Due the allies and supporters we have made you and to correct conduct. We will see a number of nations, we become one nation. And gradually, everything has been made ready for this over centuries. Now it makes sense to bring it. We have United States, 50 states or 50 nations, each one economically powerful for themselves in their way, have made one nation out of part of one continent. We've seen the connection of the Europeans together as European community. We've seen the African nations on the same path, and we've seen the Asian continent joining the same. Our job as Keshe Foundation is to make one nation out of all these groups, and we're achieving it very rapidly. And then you understand, to make one planet, one nation, one race, the work has already been done. It's just bringing the last pieces together that we bring the trust and unity. We've seen in the news in the past hours, more or less past 48 hours, that the Russians and the Chinese have sat in a camp of peace. That if there is anything done by United States against Russia, Chinese will release all the papers and dump the economy of the United States. Means China has taken the leadership of peace. Let's talk. We own most of your assets. Now we dictate the peace condition. And this is why you understand we sit with the Chinese, because the peaceful behavior brings peaceful reactions. In so many ways, us as Keshe Foundation has been given all the opportunities. It's for us, through the development of the technology and delivery of the technology, to change the position, to bring the last pieces together. The jigsaw is already on the table, all the pieces made, it needs the connection. And when the picture is added together and connected to each other, the beauty of looking at this picture is the unity of mankind, and with it, the prize, which is the opening of the universal community to man. Is it worth it to have a bigger space to look, bigger space to travel, to learn more from the man of space than to fight for a piece of land which worth nothing when the physical life of a man is over? So, as we done before, we do today again. We put the hand of peace across the table, as we did between Iran and American nation some years ago, which we led to the peace talks and completion of peace between Iran and the United States. Now we put the hand of the peace across the nations, to all the world leaders, that we give you time, but we dictating the path. We have the tools, the technology, and the manpower of thousands of the Keshe Foundation supporters to deliver step by step. At the moment, we came from the center core of a few. Now there are thousands. And each one of you is adding different parts to this mosaic of the beautiful creatures of this planet, which is mankind and the rest of it. I've been told there are people creating divisions and opening different parts on the different name of the foundation. Why not? It's your freedom. As long as you carry the ethos of the foundation, that whatever to do is to bring peace to humanity, open as many websites. Keshe Foundation families, Keshe Foundation teaching, children, agriculture, in different languages, and whatever you like. The more you do, the more beautiful colors of the table will become. is no dictatorship, is no leadership. It's us to guide each other, and whatever we do leads up to one thing, unification of mankind and world peace. We give you the tools of it. We see better and we act better. And that's what I said from the beginning. Part of the development of the space technology is not physical reactors, it's not magrav unit, is not the health unit, is not growing bigger lettuces and cleaning the waters of the rivers of Africa. It is with this process we bring peace to humanity. We start learning and we start teaching. And it is beautiful to learn from everywhere, every nationality, what you call yourself, but one common language, the peace and the soul of the man. So, from now on, we do not go so much into seeing and developing systems we have done. We have achieved to the point the man cannot understand any further. At this moment of time, even reaching the field plasma, we have reached the pinnacle of science for man, and now we know the line, we know the point where we got to achieve, we have to fill in the picture. Some of you will bring different methods, some of you develop different methods, be it for different application. None of you is wrong. Nobody is wrong. You put a double coil together, you put the GANs together, you put nanomaterial together, they all have come through the teachings of the Keshe Foundation. None of you have brought anything new on the table, but all of you have brought the knowledge of mankind on the table. So, those who try to claim they control this, or they have this, and they have the decision making of a country, or a nation, or whatever, it shows the lack of understanding of the teaching. And you getting lost again in the same process of mankind, losing its direction in understanding of the totality of the work of the Foundation. If winding couple of pieces of wires makes you the leader, if you were stacking the coils which we showed you, makes you ahead, let it be. It means you have no knowledge, you have no understanding of the work of humanity. Put as many systems, amalgamation of systems, bring the GANs and the plasma, bring the field plasma, bring the nanotechnology, bring the matter technology together, and use the beauty of it for man to achieve peace and enter a condition to be able to be the teenager, to have the key, to be able to go for excursion on his own. It is very easy to get lost, but if we have pulled beacons of light, we can always find the way back home. And this is our job. I have explained many times that how we can change things, how we allow more and more people to access the technology. We have come to the point to extend the knowledge. Today we go to Ghana if we have the bandwidth. Ghanaian Keshe Foundation, Benjamin, and the Ghanaian Atomic Commission have done a lot of work in the background. We'll see a new material today. We'll see a new approach today developed by, again, African developing nuclear center or atomic center. Today I teach you something new. How you can understand the technology in a very, very easy way. It's been on the table, but none of you ever stood still to listen to what was said. Go back to the beginning of the teaching. Go back to very first time, the very first videos we made about making nanomaterials and about making what we call the GANs. Fabio, is it possible to have the whiteboard, please? In so many ways, if we go back to the position of understanding the very first teachings, you will understand what we are teaching in the last teachings of past 2-3 weeks has already been always on the table. It's us who looked not deep enough, but so was in front that the knowledge was not understood. Let's look at two things. Let's go back on very, very original teaching. You have the matter, you have the nanomaterials. We said, and we have shown many times, very original pictures, videos, which Keshe Technology put on the internet 8 years ago, 10 years ago, carried a very beautiful collection of different materials with a diamond tester, which showed the behavior of every material. If you can find it on the internet, you see different materials using a tester shows behavior of a diamond. So, we already know how to make crystals, diamond crystals. Because diamond crystals comes only when a specific configuration is achieved, where the balanced light in rejection and acceptance of the field is created. So, what we do in the matter state with the nanomaterials which we have today, with the dark color on top of the nano layer, we only are looking in. We are not looking across. If you had a chance to look, not this way where you see the darkness, because all the rays are absorbed, but look this way, you will see the most beautiful crystal structures man ever known. That is why when you put the tools which you know, you see 20 mega ohms. But this way you see superconductivity. This is the behavior of perfect crystal. This is the behavior of creating perfect crystal. So, now you understand how to produce crystals. You've already been there, but you did not see the knowledge. Go back on the extension of the knowledge. The way we spoke about using composite. If you still use composite, use brass, different materials, you created bigger and smaller spacing in these layers of nanomaterial. Then you understand you can make the spacing in the right space, gravitational magnetic field positioning, and with it, now you can decide the size of the crystal. Because each one of these takes a position in the crystal. Spacing perfect. Structure perfect. Now, you see, it is in your hand. You already all have been crystal makers. Perfect crystals. The crystals you made are nano layers because it's so thin you don't have the tools to see are the most perfect crystals man has ever made, because it's made by allowing the nature to do what it's happy with, to do without any damage, but taking the position it likes. Now, if you understood this, those of you who've been looking to make perfect crystal, miss another point. Don't forget one thing. You put this nanomaterial into liquid of another field strength. You placed it and you released it as a gas. If you could understood if you understand now that in creating a condition to go from attachment to freedom, and you can create a condition where you can bring the freedom of the material in a spacing themselves the collectively correct way, you can create any crystal size you want. Now you have to look for a medium to be able not to let them loose to become the ganses, but create a condition that in becoming loose, they find a position, you can have a diamond the size of a planet. We've seen it, there are diamond structures in the universe, there are stars which behave and are, let's say, the structure of a crystal diamond. It's been reported by NASA years ago. So now you understand the space of the universe allows crystallization in the dimension. Is the matter and the combination of the matter which you use dictates the spacing. But now you understand how you've all been building crystals, perfect crystals, you've been releasing it, but now you have to develop a technology where you can control this freedom. Don't let them loose and collect them as gans, but collect them as crystals of the gans. This is the space crystal structure. Then you can decide to make any material in a space by controlling the fields. Let's add to the knowledge furthermore. Go back to what we talked about your CO2 box. The CO2 box which I developed and you followed, and a lot of you use it every day to make your ganses, is the operation of the universe. None of you ever understood. Too busy to see matter, that the world of matter of the man blinded the man. Let's open the knowledge. Go back to when you make the CO2 gas. You put the nano coated copper and you put a zinc plate. And then you immersed it in the water of the salt. Go back to the teaching. Go back in understanding what I continuously emphasize, but a lot of you were too busy to look at the CO2. If you remember, go back on the teaching, what we said, the gravitational magnetic field which is created by the nanomaterial in respect to matter state created the field of copper. Where this field of the copper attracted, sorry, field of carbon, where the attraction gravitational magnetic field, which now you have created here, has made a magnet for the carbon in the space around the system to be attracted to come in, to match up, and in that process, in coming in touch with oxygen of the water, created your CO2. Understand the terminology. We did not create a CO2 absorption. Go back in the teachings. We created gravitational magnetic field of carbon by choosing the appropriate materials which the division and the difference between some of their isotopes leads to creation of the environment which has gravitational magnetic field of an entity. In this case, the precise choice of the matter, nanomaterial and the matter, just gives you enough to create the strength of the fields of copper. So, what do we talk about in the past 2 or 3 weeks? field plasma technology. You have already created the plasmatic field, because the plasmatic field you created led to creation of gravitational and magnetical field in the strength of the carbon, which attracted anyone passing by. What you collected as CO2 is what this falls at the bottom, but this field never changed. What you see, after a while, your system doesn't work anymore, you don't produce that much anymore. Because the reason being is, it's not the field that is changed. You have consumed all the oxygen which was in the water. That's why your process stops. The field never changed. You change or feed oxygen into this container, you will get in CO2 for the rest of your life to come. So, understand, you have already worked with diamond, you've already been creating the most perfect diamond in the universe, in your nano layers, and now you had the knowledge, you were too busy looking at it to land at the bottom, where you are already, all of you, have been working with a field plasma. We went into detail, how that field plasma of carbon is created. Even if you put copper with copper, how is created, that it allows the fields to flow. Now, you understand, all of you from the beginning have been in the diamond business, and all of you have been in the field business. Now, let's take the step further. Let's go and add to the knowledge a slightly little bit more. Very simple. Bring the understanding of the crystals, bring the understanding of the GANS material, and now put an entity in the middle, which has nothing, but has the field of the plasma of the carbon, and you create magnetic gravitational fields, where now you can, and you have the ability to use the fields to create your crystals. I see Giovanni's mouth opening. Put your chin up. This is the truth about all of you now understanding the technology in more depth, now bringing everything together. So, if you understood this, if you understand this principle, and you can follow the principle, all of you can make any diamond, any size, any color, the size of your container. Would you like a 2-carater or a 2,000-carater? I give my biggest condolences to diamond bourses of the world. Total cost to make such a diamond will be less than 5 cents. I used to be a diamond dealer. I broke my own business. That's why I moved away from diamond business. Because I realized with what I have developed, what I had in my hand worth nothing. When you are looking for a carat of diamond, that I can make 1,000 carats of diamond. If you understand this, sooner or later, you lot will start producing diamonds, crystals, like nothing. I have seen the Innovation Center in Philippines is on the process, but they have not understood it fully. They are on the path, they have not understood it fully. But you're not very far off. You have a beautiful team in Philippines, headed by Renan, Bernie, and the others, and Douglas in the United States, and the others who will join soon. Now, you can produce crystals which carry unified, uniform fields, and you understand exactly where does this lead to. If you understand this, and you can extend the size, the shape and dimension of the crystal, go back into my teachings. Always said, the future of the spaceship program depends on the crystallization, on the crystals. Now you understand why. You make your reactor out of one crystal. Then what you have is mono, controllable, and if you understood further, star formation of crystals, unified, never losses, but the positioning of your crystals has to be a crystal itself. Then you decide the shape, the color, the strength of the what you call is your ambition to create a unified field protection, which to you, you would like to call it the spaceship. Now, the race for a space is getting hotter. Now you understand how simply in 10 minutes I change the course of humanity, if the humanity understands what's on that board. This is the beginning of the teachings of the true space technology. What we've done in the past 2 years, we have walked you through the alphabet of understanding the knowledge of the universe. Now we come to building words, letters and sentences to be able to survive in the space. You have all the tools. If I would have tried to teach you 2 years ago this, you would have been lost. But now you have gathered the knowledge step by step. A lot of you made through the whole process. Nano-coating, GANS making, field making, crystal making, and now you see where you sit. If you understand this, if you start creating conditions, you see, I don't tell you any more copper plates, zinc plates, this, that, because now you are graduates of the University of the Keshe Foundation Knowledge Seekers, all of you. So now it's for you to bring your knowledge and collectively start working together on the internet. You have the best tool. Do not dictate, but try to share. Try to understand the plasma crystal technology, what we call the field technology, can create any diamond structure. And if you create the right diamond structure of a GANS, you can create anything across the universe. You need to understand the totality of the structure. Many times this knowledge has been given to man, but man never understood. The only part man ever stuck with was the knowledge of making matter out of it, what you call pyramids. This is your pyramid. The knowledge has been shared many times, but those who were in control of understanding never understood, and those who understood a bit of it tried to become the pharaohs and the other leaders. And now at this moment of time, a number of world leaders are in the capacity of their nation, scientific and development of the military, have access to those who have taught man in the past the same, but as they don't understand, they cannot apply. Now we understand more collectively that no army and no nation will be superior to others, and is taught right across. This was done once before, but somewhere in the line the greed of the man took place. The greed of the man is very strong, but not this time. This is why we see pyramids in every corner of this planet. The knowledge was shared, but because of the lack of communication in totality, it was cascaded, but those who used it to rule. This time there are no rulers, that the knowledge is shared correctly. This is why you see pyramids across this planet. Those who understood the knowledge took it with them to use it to rule, to be better than the others. We see pyramids across this planet. Now you understand how, very simply, if you look, the pyramids in different structure are the domes of their own spaceship. But man only made what was matter important to him and not the rest of the knowledge. Now for the first time man, with the mass media we have, is allowed to develop this collectively. And then you understand what I keep on telling you. We are making you in totality ready to join the universal community through understanding of the technology, and not by just making a nano layer or I'm better because I can put some coils on top of each other. To be able to teach, not just coiling or not just nano making or not twisting wires or not adding some plasma. I have taught you, even the Christ plus his name or Buddha did not do. They were guidance of the physical conduct of the man. We have taught the full knowledge with the ethos together, which means we teach not only the understanding of the physicality, but the use and ethos of its use in the space. This be it energy, this be it material, this be it health, this be it food. I have taught the full spectrum of every need of the man in the language of the science with the ethos of the universe. So you understand, as universal messengers, we complete our work totally when the condition is ready. We have not taken to make one nanomaterial or whatever. We start teaching you how you can use the knowledge in totality to be able to survive. The basic of the need of the man in a space and ethos to use it correctly, that he can stay alive and spread the beauty of the human race in the rest of the space. Every flower brings a beauty to the bouquet on the table. Even with all the man has done wrong, man is another flower of the Creator, and they bring their beauty on the table of the creation. When you join the universal community, it's for man how long that flower will last on the table according to him understanding his own strength and his own weaknesses, and not using others' weaknesses, but using their strength to add to his knowledge, the way we've done. We bring you in, we allow you a platform for you to share, and proudly you share it that the other use it. So now, today, in a very simple teaching, you understand how all of you are in the phase, in a position to be able to become the passengers of the universe. But it's you who's choosing the level of the development according to your understanding. I have given and taught you everything. It's for you to start deciphering the teaching in the past 10 or 15 years, be it the books, be it the papers, be it in the lectures. In each lecture which I've given across, something has been released in the knowledge. It's for you to bring them totally together and start deciphering. I just deciphered a very, very small piece for you this morning. And you've seen how everything has changed this morning. You've been in love with diamonds. Now, diamonds are worthless. You've been in love with energy and the field. It's become apparent how simple it is. You've been desiring to go into space with the spaceships that can guarantee your survival and not made of aluminium and titanium, but evolves according to the environment that it's in. Now, you have the structure. I will not teach for hours. Now, we teach few minutes at a time in every teaching, but the knowledge is so deep that it'll take you years to decipher. But if you can decipher it correctly, those of you who have reached the level of maturity of understanding the totality, you should be on the verge of the creation of the first spaceships. Chinese research people are in that level. You have to understand that the Chinese government and the people within the structure of the Chinese organization at the highest level have had access to the knowledge and contact with the universal community for some times. The same has been with Russia and United States and a number of African nations. We know who, how, and how the knowledge has been transferred. But we are waiting for one response from the world leaders. Commit humanity to peace, we open the rest of the doors. I think we have given a clear indication how the knowledge has to be developed. How the knowledge we expect humanity to respond to. Let's start making tools of peace. Let's start making tools which can guarantee every man can have food or what we call energy without enslaving him from his energy for you to have. I always objected to things to be made cheap in China, that the West can have the best things, but the man who makes it in China has to suffer the separation of his children for a year, to go home for a few weeks, for the Western people to abuse it, and then when they use it, they say, it's Chinese made. What a disgrace to humanity. The energy of a man, irrespective of his color, race and position, is the same. The respect for man has to be the same. Is the lack of understanding of a white race in finding himself superior because it's the last race, like the last child in the house, kicking to be the most important one. Where the man, the first child, of a black race has been so humble because he knows he possesses all. When we stop this color division, when we stop this race separation and work as one, the way the Keshe Foundation is bringing all the what we call different races together as one, then you'll find it's the key to space operation. Don't enslave man for energy. Don't enslave man for shelter. And don't enslave man for health. Then you understand the crystal of life is the same wherever you go in space. Because in space, then you cannot be enslaved by no one and nothing, because you have the knowledge, you have the insight. As I've said, and I've written many times, we bring the knowledge of the man to the point that when we take him to universal community, he does not become the slave, an inferior creature, becomes equal. And this is a path of teaching. For years I have declared this. So now it's for you to do the same on this planet, that we are ready to go into space. Because if we go as a divided race, we'll be enslaved as a full race. We have two choices. Stand on this planet, do not attempt to leave, and stand the consequence of what this planet is due to come to, or collectively understand even the past teaching or past half an hour, become one race, understand, respect each other, and you've got to understand one thing. You've been watched all along by the outside. It's just waiting to see when you mature. And this is the process of Keshe Foundation teaching, for us collectively to mature. Understand what I put on the table. Understand how to use it. Understand how simply you can change things, because it's so simple. If you understood one fraction of what I just put on the board, you would understand a very simple physical understanding. Let's say, this is, you understand how to make it. Turn the bucket upside down. Create the fields to make the crystal. Put the head of the man who is so precious to him to hold. Put the brain of the man, and now create the crystals, the conditions of the plasmatic crystal in the brain of the man when he was damaged through a stroke. You build the cell in the confinement of the process. You build what we said, put the man in the right position and build the Gans crystals of the structure of the heart out of a child who was born with a hole in the wall of the heart. The child does not need to die, because now you have the knowledge. You have the understanding. You understand now how simple it has become. The medical team, the doctors who work with us in the background, this is a gift to you, Dr. Rodriguez. You build system to help humanity, now you see how. It's just extending the knowledge that in your system, you make the walls, but understand, you work with the field, and if you can make the right crystals instead of the cores, you dictate the field at the point, be it a brain cell or the heart of the child. Field plasma technology leading to creation in conjunction with crystal structure. Not necessarily, you do not need to see it. You do not need to see the crystal, because you can use the field of the balanced crystal, can lead to the creation of any entity within the crystal, field forces, plasma or matter state. Now you understand how simple creation is. a lot of you got lost when we showed the first coils for Magrav system, if it's a right-hand 10 and a left-hand 10, and those who wanted to discredit your integrity and the knowledge of the Keshe Foundation, they went playing with you. But it gave us a chance to see our weaknesses, where we were weak, as in understanding how easily they are still abusing us. Look at how and what is delivered. I was talking to Sylvester last night. I explained to Sylvester a very simple thing. He said to me, you know, there is this problem, you did the catalog wrong, we did the reactors were not fixed. I said, you tell anyone, those who are really here to help humanity and develop the technology for commercializing that everybody can use it, that these are the first systems. Always, this is the way the Italians do it, not the way you do it, but at least you've shown the path. Do not build on something is wrong, buildings, what I have, how I can improve it, and how I can use the knowledge of the others to improve the development of technology in sharing it. Commercialization is to share knowledge in a technical way that those who cannot understand it can use it, but be benefited by its beauty. We don't take time off. You don't take time off. We work irrespective of time and position. Today is a national holiday in Italy. Everything is shut. But you see, the men who are devoted to share the knowledge are here to make sure the camera runs, to make sure the screen is there and the knowledge can be shared. Are we going to have 360 days of holidays in space? Because now that we become one nation, we celebrate the Italian's holiday today, tomorrow will be something in Canada, the other day will be a holiday in China. So, life in the space is a life of celebration of holidays. Because we can celebrate every language's holidays and best times. We can only do that when we all have what we need and we share the knowledge and the technology together the same way. I share it freely. I wonder if you are strong enough to do the same. We know governments at the highest level have access to the spaceship program, which they see it, but they don't understand it. They've been on the tables of the national government for years. So, we invite the national governments, bring what you have in the space, technology which you've been given and you don't understand, and we unravel the secrets which you don't understand. Then, all of us become passengers of the space. All the world leaders, when they take positions, some of them who are in the strongest positions, world leaders, are given the secrets into the knowledge which has been shared to them, or by their country or nation, by the man of space. But they never stood still to ask the question, why don't we get all of it? Because the answer is very simple. You have not committed yourself to peace until that day. You'll be shown the cake, but you cannot eat it. Now, we show you how to eat the cake, because we brought the tools, the plate, and the candles to celebrate. The world does not need the leaders who spread animosity, race separation, color separation, and everything else for them try to enforce the decision of the others who put them in that position. We need leaders who understand the capability of their power, the power of their decision making to bring peace. And we see this in two world leaders at this present time. One is President Xi of China, and next to him we see President Putin. In America, we see nothing but hate, murder, producing killing machines as the youngest infant to be the most powerful one. As I said before, to very high ranking politicians. Do you know why the Iranian nation is so peaceful? Because we had the empires. We realized nothing comes of it. We'd done our conquering. Came nothing out of it. But it taught us one lesson. Killing does not bring advantage. It brings disadvantage because you have to pay for the souls which you have destroyed. So, the understanding is very simple. Try to use the technology in a very effective way. People like Dr. Rodriguez, people like Renan and Bernie, people like Benjamin, people like Alex and the rest, people like Douglas in the United States, we all committed to one thing, to bring as much knowledge as fast as possible to humanity, to change the course that man can become at peace with himself, that he finds peace with others. So, I wonder how many of you will start making crystals. If you understood, as I said, very simply, empty the bucket which you made, the gas material in it, you will find out the bucket still carries the field plasma. You were looking for the CO2, but if you look deep inside and test it, Giovanni comes to me and says, I'm testing it. There's a field in the bucket which is empty. I said, yes, we know. We know for a long time. We said we're going to teach it today. So you come with the message we already said on Tuesday. The empty bucket. Because now in your plastic bucket, you have confined the fields. Throw the water away. Throw the plates away. You have created a field, it will stay. And then you'll understand, you have a now a field bucket of carbon. Try to bring another bucket with copper oxide empty in it and put them together and see what you're going to get. Now you understand the field plasma technology. Once you create it, you never lose it. You were happy to see it in the water, now you have it in the fresh air. In what you call your containers. Test it. A lot of you test it. Put your empty container and put whatever you like in it, test your water before and check your water for the property of the CO2 after. I'll give you another piece of information which might help you. You used the liquid plasma to create the fields that what you wanted to create. Let's say you get a system, you create the CO2 fields in it and try to make a pipe which just water goes from one end and it comes the other. Here it's fully contaminated, here comes that clean water. Field plasma technology is contained by the structure of the nanomaterial. Does ever lose its strength? Do you need to produce ganses? Do you need to produce liquid plasma? And then do you need to produce vapor? Or do you create the condition of the fields and you can contain it and do whatever you like with it? In a space, you put field into it and the other end will come concrete blocks. Become steel, because you have predetermined the size of the crystal, the shape of the organization of the crystal, And by putting the right way, feel the strength, the same as you did with the patches of CO2 and the others, and you created the smell and taste of the orange. But move from plasma into the field operation. And then you start understanding, this is essential for you to understand this process. Because in the universe, you go through the conditions that you don't see CO2 fields. But with the environment around it, thousands and hundreds of thousands of kilometers, without seeing a CO2, you end up in the CO2. Because the fields of the universe have created it. And CO2 is the last thing you want. You don't want to walk into a wall of crystal. Not there, but with your presence, becomes there. Plasma field is the essence of the creation in the universe. And now, you start teaching it. Now you understand how simply, because you have the other knowledges, you can manipulate it. You can contain it. But, as humans, you needed the confirmation. I put the orange on the top, and I put some fields of gases here, I taste the orange. Look what happened. If you empty the water and breathe the air, you still get the orange taste and the smell. Make the glass vacuum, but keep the same condition. In the vacuum, you feel even smelling and eating the orange. Because man is so physical, he always needs something to do. You've done nothing different. Those of you who understood, but got lost in the process, see what you've done. You created the field of God. You've created a field with the protein around the box that brought you the smell of orange. Here, you looked for gases. Here, you had everything here to collect it. Empty the water. Taste the air. You still get a full orange. Taste, energy, and everything else. But you have to have a liquid to confirm you had something. So, you've already been in the field plasma technology. This is important, because for our medical people, if you understand it, do we need to give children anything for immunization? Except we put them through a field which embeds information in their body that measles and the rest cannot develop to kill. And then we find there's no need for pharmaceuticals to put mercury in the children to make them mentally retarded. Very simple. Very, very simple. Now, as I said, we don't go in teaching anything, we go into understanding the technical aspects of what you've learned in the past 2 years. And teaching is easy now, because you've seen it, you've done it, is not something you don't understand. Now, it opens a new door to look at the whole structure. I said, when one of you comes to a point, I teach the rest. And when somebody comes, doing things without understanding, now I give you the guidance to be able to finish it. Do we need liquid plasma for the systems which is getting developed in Philippines? You know exactly what I'm talking about, those who work in the research on that side. Do we need to carry the energy as a fuel, or can we carry the energy through understanding of it as field? And when it comes to the engine, it releases its energy, it satisfies the man need that something moves. But it'll be very interesting in the coming time, when the fields, the pistons go up and down, and there is no fuel at all in the tank. But still converts the energy of the space of the universe in a mechanical rotation that can carry the man. This is what our friends in Research Center, Innovation Center in Philippines have been doing, and they could not understand it. Maybe now it enlightens you exactly what is going on. And if you extend the power of the plasma to become equal to the matter state of the cylinders, you'll find out your car will run without the fuel. My deepest commiseration to the oil producing nations. We have just write off the whole oil industry. As I said, the teaching is becoming very fast, and those who understand will develop it very quickly. Our Chinese team, headed by Professor Xu, you are developing mass production GaN system for OASIS system. The Chinese team working in the scientific section, this is for you to understand. In mass production of the GaN system you are doing, try to create homogeneous mono GaNs and try then to use the field of the GaNs to create the condition of the structure of the crystal unit. You have to learn how to convert the energy using the position of the GaNs to interrupt the crystal condition of the energy. Your space people in Chinese Space Agency understand exactly what I'm talking about. You use one to contain the other. We use the matter to create GaNs, nanomaterial, and contain them. Now you use the condition of the GaNs to contain the plasma and then contain the fields, because it's the only way you can contain field plasma. Not by matter, but by application of the fields which come from the liquid plasma, which themselves are controlled by the GaNs, which themselves controlled by the nano and the matter state. So, if you understood this, it should be very easy for you to use your matter to create the crystals of the matter. You want the crystal of copper to be diamond, the color of the green which you are used to as CO2, now you can do. The knowledge you have to understand. The knowledge is easy, but it's for you to extend the knowledge. Is Benjamin online? Rick, can you see Benjamin behind?
I'm here.
Yes.
Good morning, Benjamin.
Hello, good morning, sir. How are you?
Not too bad. Are you ready to share with us the understanding of the holding of the plasma within the matter?
Yeah, I'm ready to share with you. Daniel is around here. He even wanted to go away, but I told him, no, you asked me to start right away, and
please,
lo and behold.
Mm-hmm. Please, so, to share the knowledge, you're achieving a beautiful dimensions in plasma technology. Let us understand.
Okay, so today we are going to share with you is a soap that we made, and Daniel, after doing it, Daniel was able to do the microbiology analysis in his lab, and then the results was amazing. The estimated bacteria killing time was within the 15 minutes range. So after 15 minutes, when you open the cultured containers, all the bacteria were gone. So he was really amazed, and he told us that, you know, this is a good product. It will sell on the market. And he wanted us to even do a further work on it. For now, we are going to share with you the hard soap, the hard one. We also have a liquid one, which is sitting on his table currently.
Can you share your screen with us? We don't see anything.
Okay, I'm going to share.
That we can see what you're talking about, please.
Okay. I'm going to share my screen with you. Share. And then, is it coming?
Yes, we see the bottles.
Okay, so that is what we are going to share today. That's Kes Foundation Ghana Nano Soap Microbiology Report. And we are currently at the Ghana Space Science Center. I'm here with Daniel from the Microbiology Lab, and he has been doing a lot of analysis with us. So I want to go straight into the PowerPoints that we have. Everybody who is watching or, you know, is listening to us, probably in his lifetime have used a soap before. And so basically a soap is a substance used together with water for washing and cleaning. And it is made up from two compounds, normally natural oils or animal fats with sodium hydroxide or another strong alkali. The fats, some people call it tallow. And normally after doing this composition, they add perfume and color to it, and then they achieve, you know, the soap. So, did you know that soap have been used for human beings at least for the last 6,000 years in one form or the other? So, I mean, it's something we cannot live without. And soap was first made by the Babylonians. And historical references point to the fact that soap making were used in the textile industry, and it is still used in the textile. And we use it to wash ourselves and then wash our clothes. And then we use it for medicine. Over here in Ghana, there are some local medicine which is soap driven. You know, they put small in the water and people use it as put it in a string as an enema. And then they, you know, so that they can wash their intestines. So that is something that I know for sure that people do here. But how safe, and, you know, our ancestors have been doing it, so I believe it's medicinally, you know, powerful. That's so. So this also there's a historical fact about soap. It was the ancient Europeans who started using soap, in France, they had a lot of factories which spread finally to Italy. And then the British also, seeing the boom in this business, jump on the train. And then the first factory was situated in Bristol in the 12th century. After that, they established another one in Cheapside in London in the 13th century. And because they got a lot of money from that, because everybody was using it, so they thought it could, you know, serve as, you know, taxing, you know, for the government. So during the Napoleonic era, government inspectors even went to homes. People were doing it illegally, so they were able to get into homes and then seize pans of soap makers, so that they will not be able to produce this product in the night. Okay, so that was what, you know, happened. Historical facts about soap. Now let's look at the modern facts. What's our trend of soap usage? It's estimated that about 10 billion pounds per year or so, you know, is used overall, and US uses one third of it. the per capita consumption is 25 pounds per, and then Netherlands followed by Netherlands, and 20 pounds by UK, Japan 7, Brazil, and so on and so forth. Okay, so the uses are classified. Web 92 and laundry. US use about 85% for laundry and 12% for toilet, so and so on. So that, this is a source from the Soap magazine that I quoted from. Okay. In doing this thing, I form a team, and some of them are on the way coming. Esther, Lebanon, myself, and Nash, and then Esther again, and then Nafisa to Adam. These are from the chemistry lab, so we decided to, you know, do this together here. So that's the team, as you see over there. And these are the ingredients we use. We use sodium hydroxide, soda ash, coconut oil, pumpkin, glycerin, shea butter, cocoa butter, fragrance, and nanomaterial, and water. So these are, you know, the stuff that we use. And I will go into details why I even chose these materials to use in the making of the soap in the first place, because it have a lot of medicinal benefits. So first of all, to get further, I want you to understand that the skin of man is the largest organ of the human body. It is easy to be poisoned through the surface of the skin easily, because when you get, that is why when you get into a mono in an environment where there's monocarbon, you can easily, because it can seep into your bloodstream faster, and then you be able to lose your life faster also. So the skin does not only protect the internal organs and systems of man, it also gives visible and emotional feedback. So when you have rashes in some part of your body, it's telling you, it's like the instrumentation panel of a car. When the red signal shows or the indicator move to E, you know that your car fuel is getting, you know, empty, so you have to fill it. The same thing applies to the body. When you, it gives you visible signs of what is happening inside. And those who have been doing the GANS partners, we have learned that this putting, creating a tray layer of, you know, a paper or a cotton layer, you are able to mimic these layers of the skin, epidermis, dermis, and then the hypodermis. This is a tray layer of the skin. So if somebody have pain, if you know, understand these things carefully, you can easily look at this structure and then bring back or restore or the health to the body, because it is basically operating based on the plasma principle of gravitational and magnetic field, the whole body, you know, of man. So as you see, also there are hair follicles, and so if hair, if water sits, a little bit of water sits on the body, you know, it can seep into the bloodstream easily, because it, there is an enabling path created by nature for any liquid to seep into the bloodstream very quickly. So, I mean, bathing even with good water or a soap which is well treated can enhance your total well-being. So that's the skin of man for you. Okay. So, like I said before, we chose the materials for this production of soap very carefully, because we believe that coconut oil have a lot of properties, okay? Because looking at the coconut itself, it's a plasma on it, on the way the water is inside the coconut, and you know, the whole structure, it's like the nature of the earth itself, okay? So coconut oil consists of healthy fat called medium chain fatty acids, MCFAs. These unique fats include caprylic acid, lauric acid, and capric acid. Okay, let me show you a little bit or give you a pictorial evidence of the medium chain fat. Okay, for instance, when you take the normal frying, you take the normal oil and then you put it on fire, and then you put a coconut oil and then you put it on another fire and set this set the fire at the same time, you see that the coconut oil, you know, burns faster than the ordinary oil. Okay, so It is easier for the body to digest, and it is also the body is able to consume coconut oil, and it is not stored at fast. And coconut oil has antimicrobial and antifungal properties. Because of this property, the cell is able to use it and release its energy quickly. So coconut oil is easily processed by the liver, because when it's fatty and it cannot melt, it is difficult for the liver to, you know, process, and it end up, you know, accumulating all kinds of filth in the liver, and it created a lot of help. It is one body part that works all the time, so it needs to be freed all the time. So coconut oil is best for your body. Like I have learned, if you want to put water in your car, if you can consume the water yourself, then you can also give it to the car. But if the water is not good for you to consume, then when you also put it in the car, it will damage. The same thing applies to if you can apply it to your body and it will suit your body well, then when it enters into your mouth also, your body can process it well. So the second ingredient we use also was cocoa butter. Cocoa butter has also anti-aging properties. That means the ladies, we are currently working on released what we are doing now. We are working on ointment also with the ganses, okay, so that you can use it to treat asthma and stuff like that, any skin disease. Cocoa butter can help improve the quality of hair. It is good also in maintaining the overall skin health. Cocoa butter can be used to reduce inflammation. It has a high quantity of antioxidant, and so it is able to fight free radicals. Okay, cocoa butter also has high fatty acid, and it is able to, because of this high fatty acid, it is able to enter into the skin very well. And then if it is infused with proper medicine, it can, you know, heal, you know, the body very well also. So the next one is, this one is plenty here in Africa in the tropical zones, and this is palm tree. And out of the palm tree we get a palm kernel oil. And if you were watching CNN or you were following what happened during the Katrina, it was one of the trees that was able to stand the storm. You know, most of the trees were falling, fell off, was hit by the hurricane, but the palm tree stood. And over here, nothing from the palm tree is thrown off. Everything is useful, right from the root to the fruit. Nothing is, you know, for me, I've used the oil. We use the whole thing for food. We use it for, you know, fuel and so many things. Okay, so we also have seen that it's loaded with zero cholesterol. That means it's good for people with Alzheimer's, you know, and people with diseases who want to reduce their cholesterol. And in that line, we can also deal with diabetes in this regard. It is loaded with antioxidant also. It is unsaturated fat, rich in vitamin K, and zero trans fat. You know, it does not store the fat. What this means, it does not store the fat. It doesn't keep it. It releases its energy, and it contains a lot of vitamin A, and it has a long shelf life. Okay. And then it's filled with other nutrients, and it can improve your hair growth, and it provides also soft skin, softness for your skin naturally. So these are inculcated, or it is part and parcel of the palm kernel. Okay, so we start with the soap making process, and that is step one. As you see, Nash with us. Nash is diluting the caustic for us, for us to dissolve in water. And that is some of the ingredients that we use, the caustic. So we have this mixture being done by him, and you can see the ash bottle over there. That's what it has, and we poured a little bit of the plastic in the cup so that he can mix it. And then after that, we went and then measured all the oil and then have it melted, and then we pour them into a mixing bowl, as you can see, and then added the soda ash slowly and then stir them, and then we Benjamin, added the
Benjamin,
yes,
you go, yes back, go back two steps and explain the last two steps again, please. Go back two frame after the coconut, yes, and the palm. Go back
this, yes, one,
yes, explain from this step by step, please.
Okay, so coconut oil has anti-aging properties. That means when you put it on, maybe your face is beginning to have lines, okay, in front of your face. The cells, as I showed in this the picture, the internet is awesome. Please, are you getting me? Am I losing you or?
Yes, yes, we can hear you and see you.
Okay, so as I said, when somebody's face start folding, we can use the coconut oil, and like I showed in the picture of the skin, the coconut oil, the cocoa butter, because of these qualities, it can penetrate into the foreskin of the skin, the skin, and then enter into the dermis, and you know, increase the, what do you call it, the overall health of the skin. So it can also add to the good quality on your, what do you call it, the skin of your hair or the scalp of your head. So when you smear it, the ladies, they know it, cocoa butter. I recently had a lot of students from different countries of Africa, the IEA students, and most of them, when I showed them the property of the cocoa butter, most of them bought, you know, huge, you know, quantities from here, and then took it to their locations, wherever they were coming in from. So that is another quality, because one of the guys from Rwanda told me it is very expensive in Rwanda to get the cocoa butter, but it's so cheap here, you know, to get. So they bought a lot of them and then carry them along. So it's good for maintaining skin health. Cocoa butter can be used to reduce inflammation. That means if somebody has pain and you mix it with the right, you know, stuff, you can also reduce inflammation of the skin. And antioxidant, cocoa butter is high in antioxidant, which help fight off free radicals. So free radicals in the blood system, if you use it, we can use it to cook as well. So using it to cook will also end up fighting these free radicals in your body. Cocoa butter has also high fatty acid. That means it have this MCFA, medium chain fatty acid, okay? And it can penetrate into the layer of the skin very well and then help heal the skin. Okay. Mr. Kesh, should I go over this again?
No, go back, go down. So you just explain, go to the next page, how you make the soap.
Okay, so making the soap was simple. That, as you see in the picture, that is Nash, you know, measuring the caustic and dissolving it in the conical flask, as you see over there. And then after this, we measured all the oils and then have them melted, and then we pour them into a mixing bowl, as you can see it here, and then added the NOH, that's the sodium hydroxide, and continue stirring until a thick mixture until a thick mixture is obtained, and then we added the fragrance. Okay, we added fragrance. Okay. After this step, we then continue stirring on, we added guns and stirred it until it was evenly mixed up in this the soap mixture. That's, as you can see over here.
What kind of gowns did you add?
So we, as you can see over here, we have CO2, we have CH3, and then we have copper oxide. So we did a lot of configuration. That I will show it in the next slide. So that is it. This part is the palm kernel oil, the one with the red fruit. That's the palm kernel oil. And then the white ones over here are the coconut oil. As you can see, if you look at the picture, you see at the lid edge of the plastic containers, you have copper oxide gas, okay? And then you have CO2 plus CH3, you know, and then we have control and then control also. But this is just a little bit of what we have, because we did a different configuration because of what you are looking out for, which I will explain in the jiffy. We have copper oxide plus CO2, and then we have different configurations, CH3 and copper oxide, CH3 and CO2 mixed together, and then some went, you know, on their separate, you know, containers. Okay, so if you have understood the plasma, the science behind this plasma, and if you are interpreting it physically, you see that the CO2 controls the blood system or the motions, okay, and then the CH3 controls your neural system, that is the energy flow, and then the copper oxide controls the lymph system, which has to do with your physical well-being or your physicality or your the physical structure. So if somebody, as I have seen, and I've seen it always and always here, when somebody have deep pain, like people, somebody have a pain on the hand or a swell or a sore on the hand, and then you apply the gans, normally they are in pain immediately, but afterwards when you apply the three layers on the skin, these people suddenly go to sleep quickly. They go to sleep quickly and immediately. If Nash was around, he would, you know, confirm that when he had burns on the hand and the doctors were, you know, drilling him here, go and come tomorrow, and I said, why don't you let me try this on your skin, and he allowed me to treat him. He, but the following day, I think the next day after treatment, he came to me and said, Benjamin, even if I sleep, even if it's 1 hour, it is, you know, good. I feel so good about it. And after 1 week, the whole thing was gone, and fire burns, which normally leave a scar, you know, left no trace of scar on the skin. If you were, he was, you know, around, he would have, you know, shown it to you, like you can see. There's no, he will show you the area where he experienced the burn. There's no physical trace of the burn, and the skin looked beautiful, you know. So that is the representation. So we were looking for energy flow where we wanted to deal. If we are looking for something that will help improve your emotions, make you happy, then we add, we use the CH3 and then the CO2 gans. And then where we're dealing with pain and stuff like that, we mix the copper oxide gans and then the CO2 gans. And then where we wanted to increase the field of, you know, the emotions also, we use the CH3, you know, gans, because when you're talking about CH3, you are talking of field amplification, which has to do with the CH3 gans. Okay, so that is the various nano gans compositions. So after this, you can see that this, we left the soap, you know, allowing the soap to cure. What is mean by curing is we allow the soap to sit so that the water used in preparing the soap, you know, evaporates, because you use water, distilled water, in dissolving the sodium hydroxide. So Curing means simply you allow the soap to sit for weeks, 4 to 6 weeks. During this time, the water used in the recipe evaporates. And the advantage here is that the cure soap has a firmer texture and it lasts for longer in shower. Okay, so as you can see here, this one have CO2 guns and then CO control. We selected this one so we can show it to you. The coconut oil is still, has the liquid texture after even the weeks of sitting. Okay, but this the white one, the one which appears white on the surface, is hard and very hard because it had the guns in it. And this is the palm kernel oil. They almost look the same, but when you feel it, you can see the difference also. The one with the copper oxide is also harder. Okay, so that is what you can see on the PowerPoint. At this juncture, after the 6 weeks time, we decided to package the soap and then send it to the microbiology lab for analysis. So we had a lot of Ziploc bags and then labeled them with various code, which I'm revealing it to Daniel now because he didn't know what was inside. We wanted to do a blind study so that he doesn't, influence the results anyway. So we labeled it. What you see here is HS. HS means hard soap, and then the L is lab. So HSL lab, that is hard soap that was made in the lab. And as you can see, there are also some bottles here. And I don't have, because we'll be doing the next time, I will show you how the bottles are looking. They are collapsing on themselves because the guns energy, the energy released by the guns is so much that it is shocking everything. You can see the bottles, and he's here to testify of it. So as you can see, HSL5, okay, HLS3, and so on. And we gave him a large spectrum of samples that he said it was so plenty and it couldn't match the number of petri dishes that they had in the lab. So we have to go out and then look for some more, for him to be able to analyze the stuff for us. And as you can see, these are the petri dishes that incubation period, and I'm going to hand it over to him because this is his part. He's going to deal with the microbiology aspect of it, and then we'll see how effective the guns behaved on the pathogens. And talking about pathogens, he will go into details about the pathogens we are dealing with here. We are dealing with Staphylococcus aureus, and then we are dealing with E. coli, and then we are Salmonella typhi, which can affect human beings. So that is what Daniel will be sharing with us in the next couple of slides, so that you can have it. Nash is also around now. Nash is around. I'm handing over to Daniel.
Okay, so good morning. I'm Daniel Labi, microbiology lab.
Thank you very much for sharing knowledge with us.
Yes, thank you too. Okay, so this is how the work started. We prepared a 24-hour culture of Escherichia coli, Salmonella typhimurium, and Staphylococcus aureus, which are all pathogenic organisms that we isolated from beef. Okay, so these are the organisms we use for the work. And this is how the Staphylococcus looks like on a plate. And this is actually what we isolated in the lab. It's not a picture. Yeah, so Staphylococcus aureus is a type of bacteria. And it strain, it stains positive, and it's non-motile, small round shape or non-motile cocci. In that microscopically they are clustered, they are not in chains. There are two types. We have Streptococcus, which is in chains. Then there's Staphylococcus. That is how to differentiate them. Staphylococcus is always in a cluster form. Okay, then this is also how the E. coli looks like. It is the most prevalent infection organism in the family of gram-negative bacteria known as the Enterobacteriaceae. Enterobacteriaceae are microorganisms that are found in the intestines of animals, both human beings and animals. Then this is also Salmonella typhi, a very infectious organism. Okay, so this is how the work was done. We prepared three concentrations from each soap sample that was brought to the lab. 10%, 30, and then 50% were prepared by dissolving. We dissolved them in 100 ml of distilled water in a 250 ml container, and we left them overnight to dissolve completely. Okay. Okay, so after preparation, leaving them overnight to dissolve, we added 1 ml of the test organisms that we used for the test. And the test organism, we prepared an inoculum. The inoculum was prepared with a McFarland standard, which is usually of a 1.2 times 10 to the power 8. That is a lot of microorganisms. And we prepared them in a McCartney bottles and prepared a serial dilution out of it, two-fold dilution, because from the assurance Benjamin gave me that the soaps are very effective. So we prepared only two-fold dilutions. And to my surprise, after a killing time of 15 minutes, all the organisms were eliminated as shown in the plates. You know, we have 50%, 10%, and then 30%. These are the plates that represent for Escherichia coli. All of them were eliminated. Okay. Okay. So pure colonies of Salmonella appear red. That is when, if they are like I have shown, this is Salmonella. This is how it looks like. Yeah. So pure colony of Salmonella appear red with or without a distinct black spots at the center of XLD. XLD is the media that Salmonella glows on. Cellulose, oxygen, deoxychocolate, agar. Then typical colonies of Staphylococcus aureus also appear black with a clear zone around on the media. Bird Parker agar, that's BP agar. So this is the results for all the soaps were three. So we prepared three concentrations from each, 50%, 30%, and then 10%. But for HSL1, HSL1, the quantity was not up to the expectation, so we couldn't prepare 50%. What we had, I think, 33% point 86. Okay, so the colony forming unit that you see, those are the counts, the expected count from each plate. Nothing was detected there. That's why you see 0000. Okay.
Excuse me, can you go back? So what does this mean? The application after 15 minutes shows yes. No E. coli, no Salmonella, no...
No Salmonella, no stuff.
Doesn't matter yes. Which soap you used, which concentration.
Yeah, which concentration, everything went off. So with the liquid ones in the lab now, we are going to reduce the concentration to 5, 10, and 15 to see if it can still be effective. So it's to either we reduce the concentration or reduce the concentration of the GANS that is added to the soaps to see the minimum inhibitory effect. So for this one, the minimum inhibitory effect was 10%.
And your total residual at the end is zero. You couldn't find any.
Yeah, zero, yes. There was nothing there.
Okay. Go ahead, please.
Okay. So that is the conclusion. It is very performance. No.
Can you tell us what's your conclusion?
Okay, so no, where the from the resources can be, it's very obvious. The soap is very effective. It's very effective. So as I said, with the next one, we are going to reduce the GANS to see how effective it will still be. I understand this one, they added 1 mL of the GANS, so we are reducing it to 0.5 in the next analysis and see how it will go.
That's beautiful. Thank you very much. What's your conclusion? We saw the conclusion, he went back up.
Okay.
So the conclusion is that because of this performance, because of this, it has proven to be effective, and currently we are doing another, what do you call it, test on the soap. We have samples on the test in the lab, the liquid soap, which is undergoing a similar analysis in the microbiology lab at his place. And so, like he said, we are reducing the sample, the quantity of the GANS use, and we want to try the effectiveness. We want to carry another sample whereby people will wash their hands with the soap, and then we'll analyze it. We'll analyze this the effectiveness. And I was talking with the microbiologist from the Water Research Institute, and he said the very best place to do this are the public toilets, you know. And so we're going to take samples of water and the soap to that place, and then they'll wash, and then we'll collect the samples, and then we'll analyze the water and see. Before and after, we'll allow some people to wash their hands in the clean water before washing it in the nano environment, the nano soup environment, and then we will test the effectiveness of this. So that's the next test that we want to, as part of the, to test the efficacy of this and the performance of the nano soup. You know, we want to do that. And then the next projects, you know, is for treatment of various skin ailments. That's what we want to do. GANS based coconut oil ointment and GANS based palm kernel oil and ointment. That's our next projects, and which I'll be doing with Esther. You know, she just came in. Esther is here. She just came in. So that's what we'll be doing, and. So that is it, Mr. Keshe. You have any question.
Yes, I have a very big question. And what I would like you to do, what I would like you to go, is to go all the way back to very first 2, 3, 4 frames of this presentation, please. Go back all the way. Stop. Go one frame forward, please. Go to the next frame. Yes. And now go to the next frame where you speak how you produce soap.
Okay. So this place.
Okay, now go to the next picture, please. Remember this, go to the next picture. What did you do? You added
here.
No, go the one before which you had the NaOH on it before this.
Mm-hmm.
This is important.
Before. No,
okay.
Before.
Wait. No, no, no. Where you were? Stay where you were. Just go back. Go to the one with the NaOH. Mm-hmm. Okay. In your talks, you're in a perfect frame. In the teaching, you showed us historically people add caustic to the fat, caustic to oil. So, if you stand still with the present knowledge we have, man already has been in the gas making system and nano making system for centuries. You add caustic to amino acid, to fat, to human fat. And now you understand. You go and get the water from the sea and you add NaOH to it to make what you call the sea gas. Man has been making protein gas for centuries. Soap is a type of natural gas with amino acid. If you understood this, now you understand we have all been gas makers the way we've been nanomaterial makers for centuries without knowing. The reason, do you understand? Benjamin?
Yes, sir.
Do you understand what it means?
Yeah. I'll add a contribution to it. If you people have watched the movie Fight Club, when Brad Pitt was narrating to his apprentice or the guy he wanted to recruit, he went to where the beautician clinic and then collected the fat of human beings. What the fat people, when they get to this clinic, their fat is sucked, and then that is what this guy used in preparing the soap. And he sells the soap to the same people who gets to the beauty clinic to go and take the fat. And they didn't know the content of the soap. And so this guy was asking him, his apprentice was asking him, why do we use this thing? He said, to make the best soap, you need tallow. That's the fat of human beings or animals. And then he went on further to say, the ancient people discovered that in some part of rivers, they were able to wash their things properly. Why? Because on the hills where the rivers flow, that is where the human sacrifices were made in those days. So the ashes, when it rains, the ashes are carried along and it mixes it with the wood ash. And the wood ash end up forming soap. And so that is how, those portion of the rivers, form. And they didn't understand the principles, but they ended up, getting the soap or getting something to wash their clothes. So I mean, this knowledge have been with us, like you just said, since time immemorial. But we human beings have refused to learn. And sometimes when you tell people about the technology, it looks so simple that they begin to doubt, what the efficacy or effectiveness.
They doubt their own intelligence. why I asked you to come to this frame is that to show, and we expand on it as you are, that in fact soap is a gas state of protein, the fat.
Mm-hmm.
So now it should have been no surprise why when you add another gas to a presently a state of gas, you increase
the
potency to higher than the protein which was made by itself. That's why when you added CO2, when you added CuO, or when you added CH3, all work on Salmonella and all the other bacteria, because the foundation of the soap you made is already amino acid based. So all you need, all you've done, you added additional energy. In a way, you created a new virus. Because the amino acid GANS is still there, which made a soap. Now you have made a virus which is stronger than Salmonella and everything else. And now, for the first time, you understand why your soaps work, kills bacteria. Because you have made a new virus, which is the energy of the CO2 added to the present GANS amino acid, which you created. And this is why it's so effective. In this new energy package which you have created, adding a GANS energy to another GANS energy, is more than what is held in the body of the man as viruses. And that's why you see destruction. You can go to the minimum amount of GANS. Don't use GANS in your next test, just use the water of the GANS.
You will get GANS. Yeah, that's...
You understand? Mm-hmm. Because now
yes, sir.
you have added to the energy of the GANS of the amino acid, which you call soap. So this, for a lot of you, it becomes a new knowledge. Why the GANS works on bacteria. This, what you show us today, I wish we could go directly to South Ceylonian University, to the professors in the biology lab, in micro lab, which they did the same test 2 years ago, and they came out with the same result. But the World Health Organization blocked them to come out with the technology which was given by Keshe Foundation to them to stop the E. coli and the Ebola. And they were threatened to lose their seats as professors in the university. Now, for the first time, we see with the scientists like you in Ghana, in what they call Atomic Agency, that you're confirming what your colleague in South Sierra Leone University did 2 years ago and submitted at the presidential office to the World Health Authority. All the equipments were taken off of them and they were told they cannot show such a thing. Now it's in public. But we understand the way how it works. The reason your scientists in the Atomic Energy Authority Research Lab see the reduction in all the what you call bacteria or viruses is because any bacteria, any virus has a base amino acid. So with your soap, you have already created a base amino acid by adding another energy to it with your GANS of CO2 or copper oxide or CHT or any GANS you add to it, the power of it becomes more than the bacteria or the virus which is in the stomach, Salmonella or whatever. And the transfer of the energy from one to one shows you the reduction total, because you transfer energy from the bacteria or the virus, which already have a common denominator of the amino acid of the protein. This is how it works. Understand the science behind it. Not just coming up with figures, because when you understand it, you can explain it easily. Now, you see why I asked you to come to this. This is what you need to do in a space. You have a common denominator. You're in the space lab of the Ghana Atomic Energy Authority. That's where we work with. This is our base home. So when Ghana produces the first spaceships into space, the knowledge you brought from Ghana's Atomic Energy Group gives you a step forward to understand how to protect man in a space. You need to have amino acid condition, power strength, in MagRav, magnetic gravitational, which you can add slightly more to it, you guarantee life. You did not destroy the amino acid of the bacteria or the virus in your culture. All you've done is you depleted the energy of it. That's why it's left black. That's why you still see it and it doesn't air. Because the amino, if you take the residual of the culture plates which you have, which the Dr. Nash and the others just explained to us, and analyze it, you will find out it's a pure amino acid. That you haven't destroyed, you depleted the energy. This is what we call space technology, understanding the transfer of energy of the plasma. And in a very simple way, with a soap, you break a fantastic new knowledge in the world of space technology. This is what your scientists in the lab have to understand and start working on. This is what you need. Do you understand? Benjamin, are you with us? Or have we lost him? Hello? Are we here?
We are back. Yeah, we are back.
You're back. Okay.
Yeah.
Now you have to, as a man who understands the plasma and GANS and nanotechnology, transfer this knowledge to the scientists in the Space Institute, into Space Institute and a biology lab. Explain to them, they are sitting with you, we thank you for the knowledge you brought us, and we thank you for what you shared. In the purity of the knowledge, we just add to it. And now, it should be very easy, even if you add a small amount of, let's say 0.5% of soap, if the energy of that 0.5% is more than the bacterias which are within the sample test, they will share energy, you still will have amino acid at the end. Please test the residual which you left there, which you say they are black or they are there, those will show in test to be a pure amino acid in nanostructure themselves. Is it possible to do that? Do you have the facilities to do that? Benjamin? They have connection issues. Pardon?
Mr. Keshe, we lost you for some couple of minutes. So we want to repeat yourself, your question and okay. Your demand.
What it is your job, now you understand that you've been producing, human race has been producing the GANS of protein, and now you added the GANS of another material to increase the strength, in the way you made the virus, to, with it, you created a safe virus, which we control, is within our structure, that it could deplete the energy of the other viruses, being E. coli, Ebola, or Salmonella. It'll be interesting if you can take those black spots, what you say there is no culture, and see if there is still that amino acid without the energy of the virus or bacteria. And this confirms the correctness of the technology, that you're depleting energy. So we can use soap, literally caustic or ash with human protein or any kind of protein, and add a small amount of energy to it, which is safe for us to overcome any virus or disease on this planet. You can digest it. You can use the GANS of the water, use the water of the GANS of the soap and the water of the GANS of what you made as a soap, and take a spoonful of it for any kind of Salmonella which a man takes within seconds, within minutes, you see them finishing with Salmonella. So the soap, the way you made it, the way you added CO2, if you test it as a water of the GANS on a human body, you will find out Salmonella will walk away in no time, in few seconds. If you have a Salmonella poisoning, you have Ebola or your E. coli, or any kind of virus infection from any microbes or virus, just take the water of it. If it enters your digestion system, you can make these soaps as a water, which you made as a patches, and put it on the stomach, put it on the digestion system. You don't need to digest it. The energy transfer, you'll find out Salmonella disappears in no time. Do you understand? Are you there, Benjamin?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I understand.
You understand?
I fully understand. That is why I told him that it will eliminate the virus, pathogens or microorganism in no time. But they were looking. He was a little bit skeptical at first, but after he said it worked as you told me, and he was happy with the results.
No, but you have to understand the process, what is happening, not the result. So you can repeat the process with the gas of the soap and the CO2 in the patches the way you make, and put it on anybody suffers from E. coli or Ebola or Salmonella or any other infection, that you can put it on their body, and the energy transfer will do the same thing without digesting it or using it. So it'll be interesting if you put this culture material and don't mix with it any of the soap. Put it in the environment of the soap, seal it, and see if the same thing happens to the bacteria. You understand? So you don't mix your culture with the soap. You put the culture with the bacteria and virus in it, in the soap which is already CO2 or copper oxide or whatever with the soap, and see if the bacteria changes and becomes ineffective. So we don't need to eat it, we don't need to drink it, we use this energy to see the conversion. Is that possible? Or
it's possible. Yeah. It's possible. Yeah. It's possible.
Just rub the soap on the culture box and see if the bacteria start disappearing where you only left with amino acid. Make the soap and drop the culture box in it. Let it float in it without soap penetrating into the culture plate. And let us know.
Mr. Keshe, this is Ali speaking. You were talking about the diamonds, and I wanted to share something on my screen.
No, we are not going there. Stay out for the time being.
Okay, thank you.
So, what is important is to transfer the energy of the GANS, not the GANS itself. You understand?
Yes, sir.
So please come back to us if the result is correct or how much you have to increase the intensity. But don't forget, some culture plates, if it's glass or if it's plastic, will not or absorb some of the energy. This is very important. We see this when we create plasmatic fields. When you use field of plasma, depends if you use glass or plastic, different strength fields interacts. So you don't need to have the soap. You can even make the water of the soap and the water of the GANS on the top when you mix it, let the water settle. And if anybody has a Salmonella or E. coli, or you can do the testing, you should see instantaneously the reduction and transfer of the microbe or virus into only protein, where the energy is transferred into the plasma of the rest of the GANS, which you do. You don't kill the bacteria, you don't destroy the bacteria. This is one of the things we always had a huge problem with nuclear centers. When they do the Raman spectroscopy, they don't see the energy. They see the effect of the energy and they see the material. They say, this is the material, but we don't see anything different. Because GANS transfers energy, because it is a plasma. So do some tests for us and come back, because it takes you 5 minutes to do this test.
Yeah. It's not me, it's Daniel. If his outfit doesn't have a lot of work, then he can do it quickly for us. But sometimes they are loaded with a lot of jobs, so getting him do some of this thing for us quickly takes a lot of, you know.
Move him into the Keshe Foundation side of the research. Then you have him all the time.
Okay.
Now, you have Now you're part of the structure of Ghana Atomic, and we are embedded as company in there, getting done, moving into the Keshe Foundation SSI of the what do you call it, the institute, and then it'll be yours. It's just speak with the directors if we can pinch. Then it's full time.
Okay.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Do you have any questions?
The skin of Dr. Nash.
Is it? Dr. Nash is here. Nash, he wants to see your skin.
The skin? You were going to cross the skin.
Let's see which of the camera will come.
Is that the...
Yeah, he wants to see your hand. Mr. Keshe is coming. He will show you the skin.
You have to share the camera. We have lost you. We just got your voice. You got to share your camera. Yes.
Can you see me?
No.
Video
we
settings.
Have the voice, but we don't see the picture. Wait, is that with our side or is it with their side?
Somebody has to highlight the video and zoom here, Vince.
Yeah, okay. They're coming back to see the picture. Okay.
Okay, Nash, you show your hand sir, to them.
Hello, Dr. Nash.
Okay. That is the hand of Nash, which was treated with the guns. In fact, he's here, so he can tell you what happened to the hand.
Good morning, Mr. Keshe.
Hi, good morning, Dr. Nash.
As you can see the picture, my hand is almost taking the natural skin.
You need to go further down the arm. We see your elbow and up.
Okay. Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tell us how the accident happened.
Yeah, after I've sustained the burns, Ben came round. I showed it to him and he assured me that he can treat it in a matter of days. So every day he comes round to treat my hand. And just the second day I started seeing changes. And as we can see now, my skin has, the place has toned up with my natural skin. And even the hair there, which used not to grow as before, it's now growing faster as I can see. So actually the guns have worked and it's so marvelous. And if I show my hand to someone that's where I had the accident, they tend not to even believe it. But it's actually worked.
What was the accident?
I had it in, I was driving when I veered off the road, hit two other cars by the roadside, and my hand was on the steering wheel. So when the airbags popped up, because my hand was the first or the nearest object to the airbag, it scratched the lower part of my arm, getting to the main vein, that's the arteries there. But fortunately, and God being so merciful, it didn't touch my vein, so I didn't bleed. Only that I sustained severe burns at that portion of my hand.
And how long ago is that?
I had the accident 25th January this year.
Uh-huh.
And the treatment just took barely 5 days.
5 days.
5 days, yes.
So since January, there was no change. And now?
Yeah, after the sore has been healed, then the skin, I stopped. I stopped going to the clinic altogether. And I used the guns treatment for just 5 days. And I removed the gauze. And it started taking the natural skin from then on.
That's beautiful. Thank you very much. Benjamin, you need to buy two headphones that you don't need to pinch the others.
I'll do that.
Thank you very much for sharing knowledge with us. let us know when you do the test and how we can go. Thank you, Dr. Nash. Okay. Thank you for all of
I don't know whether the folks here have a question or they want to ask anything. So there are a lot of them here. Students from various universities doing their practical attachments here. And their internship here. And there are other staff or colleagues. My team, most of them are here. Esther is here. Esther, come around from the...
Would you like to make the announcement or do you want me to make the announcement, Benjamin?
Which one? Any of the two. But I will prefer you doing that.
So, okay.
That is Esther here. And hello. Behind Esther, behind her directly is Lebanon. And then Sharif is also here. So Sharif, wave your hand for them to see. Lebanon, wave your hand. And then Esther is right with me here. And Nafisa is right over there. Nafisa is here. Nafisa, wave your hand for them to see. They were all part of the soap making process. So that's my team here. My team in the, and then Nash himself is around. So that's Nash here. Yeah. Okay.
Thank you very much. As I said, the African nations will lead the space technology. And we see it now. You bring in knowledge so freely on condition of patents and scientific papers. You show the raw state of matter. And I assure you one thing, hundreds of thousands of the scientists around the world watch this program. You are watched by the world leaders today while you are presenting. And they are understanding how easy we share knowledge in this foundation. And I thank you for doing it. But we have a surprise for you. In August of this month, Keshe Foundation will hold a summit in Ghana for the African nations. So all the African Keshe Foundations, in having problem in getting visa to come to Europe, we organize the first Keshe Foundation summit in Ghana with the help of the Ghanaian Keshe Foundation, and it's on the shoulder of the Benjamin, Alex, and Dr. Gota to see this through. This is the first time we are organizing in Africa, and we are organizing in the center of Africa.
So Mr. Keshe, the people want to know, although I know what we are going to discuss about this in the summit, the people want to know what the summit is all about on
we will dimension. We will release it. It's the scientific, it's for Ghana to enter into space technology, plus the way you are doing it, and we'll try to be there. I'll try to be in Ghana for the summit, and at the same time, by then, we should be able to see different application of the space technology on the health. And as we came to Ghana through Dr. Nana, where as part of the spaceship program of the Ghanaian government, now we bring the knowledge that Ghana can join China and the others on the edge of the space, as you've done. The beauty of it is you don't realize what you just dispersed as a knowledge in Passau. You open one of the biggest mysteries of man for 6,000 years, how it works. So simply, it's not what you bring as pieces of papers or culturing. It's the knowledge which you share so unconditionally. Now really we can see, this paper you just shown, this simple presentation by such a beautiful scientist like you lot, broken all the rules of the present economical cycle. What you just showed, how easily these bacteria can be defeated or can be balanced, has been the dream of the world of medicine. Thousands of people die because of these bacteria every day around the world. Salmonella, and the others. And with a simple presentation, you brought everything to a stop. The knowledge you shared in past hour has been the dream of humanity for thousands of years to solve. And so, humbly you've done. Today, microbiologists, the leading pharmaceutical organizations around the world, are kicking themselves. The term of selling things are finished. Ghana comes on presentation. You've been watched by the world leaders. I assure you today, the program you presented has been watched by President Obama. Chinese leadership is online most of the time. Are you still there?
Yes, sir.
You've been watched by NASA, you've been watched by the health authority organizations, you've been watched by the most leading scientific organizations around the world. We speak to them and we know that they're online. We monitor them. So, in a very simple way, you've shown there is no need for peer review to control. You have destroyed half of the soap industry in the world. You destroyed half of the pharmaceutical business in the world, where the man can make a caustic with some animal fat from the steak left last night on the table, have the caustic of the fat, add a little bit of oxide from the copper of the wire in the house, you can cure a salmonella. You can cure Ebola and E. coli. When your colleagues in South University, we taught them how to make the same thing as you just shown us 2 years ago, and they took it to the presidential palace of the president of the Sierra Leone to show to the health authority, World Health Authority, which were there, how easily Ebola and E. coli can be destroyed, they confiscated and they threatened and lose their position. Now you've shown they cannot silence 20 beautiful scientists like you in Ghana. Now the whole world knows how correct the technology is because you presented it. What you presented in about past half an hour, you've been working past 6 weeks, has taken scientists of the world hundreds of years to solve. And there it is. If the pharmaceuticals understand it, you do the test with the energy, just use it as a liquid soap, as a liquid water of the soap, and use it, you will find out no child in Africa should die of any more bacteria and diseases. And Africa will head walking the man out of diseases. This is what is the beautiful thing about it. So, but the most important part is understand the principle behind it. How it is you produce the GANS of the bacteria, amino acid, which is the structure of the man, you produce added stronger, a little bit stronger strength to it by CH2 or CO2, and now that little bit of a strength in the plasmatic condition is enough to deplete another amino acid which has a little bit of strength, you call it salmonella, or the others which have been killing you. So you can literally walk your children of Africa out of all disasters. No child. Don't forget, if you have Alex on the line with you, doctors in Nigeria are doing the same thing as you do with GANS water, and people are walking away with malaria. Try, use the water of the soap you made and give it to the people who have malaria attack and watch how within 24 hours they change their position. Try it. Test it on the malaria and see how it works. Spray the rooms with the water of the soap of these cancers and see if you can overcome malaria in no time. I lost my heart to Africa 25 years ago. I worked in Africa a long time and I've seen how my workers suffered from malaria. And now you have the solution. I worked in Gambia. And I've seen my people, how they suffered. They can't afford to pay for an injection of malaria. Now you can give them a water, cost nothing, they can walk away and with no suffering. I've seen the same thing in Kinshasa for years. So, It's time for Ghana Space Institute and Ghana Atomic to deliver the first material against malaria and all the things which has been suffering while causing problem in Africa. I thank you for what you delivered.
Mr. Keshe, I'm not cutting you in. I wanted to try it with the veterinary people here. There is a veterinary unit of the Ghana Atomic Energy Commission, and I'm trying to work with the animals also. So it's something that I'm doing, but I didn't want to break the ice until you brought it in. So this the next thing I'll be doing with the veterinary people here. With they have a lot of animals, so and animals respond to treatment even faster than human beings because they have no attachments or whatsoever. So I'm going to do that with the veterinary unit also for the animal health also, and I will give you a feedback of what I find also there.
That's perfect. Let me add to what you're saying. The you can use the same material in agriculture for pest control without chemicals. You can do, you don't destroy the life of the whatever, you change the environment that they cannot exist in. You have to understand how it works. When you use these water of these soaps in the field, in the agriculture side, they just change the field strength, the same as you did with the bacteria of Salmonella and the rest. So in that environment, the pests cannot exist, so you don't need to use chemicals, you use the same water. You can extend the knowledge. We've done this, it's been done in Brazil, it's done in China, and very soon the Chinese scientists will bring this knowledge in. So now you understand how it works, it's just transfer of energy. You create a new environment, so you can use it for anything. Today we announce the establishment of agriculture at keshefoundation.org. Headed by Dr. Guta.
Guta.
Is set up, yes, in Kenya. He's been asked, this website is set, and from next Wednesday or the Wednesday after, we teach on Wednesday mornings to the agriculture scientists. If you're involved in agriculture in Africa or anywhere around the world, the way we are teaching doctors on Wednesday afternoon, on Wednesday mornings, we start teaching the agriculturists, because we ask you to come in, bring your technology that we can share. The teachings will be headed by Dr. Guta. And as I said, we're bringing leading scientists around the world to head different sections of the Keshe Foundation. And now it'll be done from Kenya. Dr. Guta is coming to Ghana very soon to be with you to share knowledge. He is a well-respected researcher and developer of the agriculture side. Understand the technology you just developed and shared with us so freely and beautifully with him in regarding the agriculture. Then you understand, you don't need to bring any fertilizer, you don't bring any pesticides from anywhere around the world. Ghana will export water out of Ghana to its own culture. Understand the principle. Understand the technology, understand the physiology of the interaction of creating new environment. Now you can become astronauts in no time. You develop it, you play with the same energy in creating lift and motion. When I met Dr. Ghana in Italy last, earlier on this year?
Last year.
Yes, in conference, peace conference, I explained to her, we bring Ghana and Africa to be the crown jewel of space technology. And today is the example of it. So unconditionally, so humbly you sit there and you change the course of humanity in a very simple presentation. If you had somebody from Harvard or Oxford, they would have been sitting there with the tie expecting respect, I know too much. Africa is humble and we respect you for it. I hope we share more with you next week, tested without the material. And on the other hand, on the Keshe Foundation, Universal Council on the Facebook, Caroline has already established a veterinarian section for those scientists who want to participate and add to the knowledge using the plasma technology to share with the others. When you go to Universal Council, veterinarian section, you can see how you can help your animals using what you just shared. Thank you very much, Benjamin. Thank you very much.
Mr. Nash wants to ask you a question, so...
Nash. Please.
Mr. Keshe, from today's presentation on the soap, if someone is diagnosed with a typhoid fever, can that person be treated?
Yes.
Using gum water or soap?
Yes. Yes, immediately. This test, influenza and these kind of things, has been tested by TEPCO Japanese Nuclear Center for helping their people in Fukushima, in the winter cold. So all you need to do, and actually our Japan Keshe Foundation, Mr. Kan-san, showed the research which was done by TEPCO, where they put influenza on the food of the mouse, and afterwards there were no toxicity in the liver and there were no influenza. You can use it, use the water of it. Use the water of the soap, not the gas itself. Gas is too powerful. If you see, if you put 0.5 mil, you still get the same result. You can see you bombarded those poor bacteria in those plates by Hiroshima bomb. That's why they are not there. So, what you got to understand, dilute it with the water in the ratio of 10 to 1. Every, let's say, 100 ml of the soap with the CO2, or try to use CO2 gas water first and see you get a result. You can use the copper oxide gas water with the soap. It'll be very powerful. It's a big punch. You understand? So use it three times, like 2 tablespoons. Yeah? And 2-3 times a day. Slowly let the body take it. Don't use a copper oxide water gas. It's too powerful. It's a bigger punch. Yeah? And you can walk them away with it. They'll walk away with that, because the research from Japan confirms your idea is correct, because we have data, we know it works. And it's done by TEPCO, the biggest research centers in energy production in Japan. Maybe we can announce something which will come to you in talking about the water. A lot of you know the organization called Umoto in Japan. With the water testing, they are well known. Mr. Umoto, and where he showed the love on it and everything else. Keshe Foundation is in negotiation development of the processes with Umoto Group. Mr. Hiro Umoto, this is thanks to the work of Sylvester. We have delivered and we started, the final tests are done this week. We hopefully announce the cooperation of the Keshe Foundation with the Umoto Group with development of these kind of waters across the world. So we are going into participation with the major players in the world of science. And we, thanks to Sylvester, we delivered material. I received a text this morning that in the lab, just understanding the potency of it. And in the coming weeks, a joint venture company between Keshe Foundation and Umoto Group will be established in Japan for delivery of these kind of materials for different diseases and radiation. You can use these waters for all kind of influenzas, all kind of digestion of the heavy metals. If you have people with the digestion of metals, you can give them the water of the soap, and then you will see they reject the metal from the body. Mercury can be rejected, but with mercury, do not use CH3. With mercury, use only CO2, no copper oxide. Yeah. So the people who have like MS, a lot of MSs, or a lot of mental diseases caused through mercury fillings. Now, if you give them CO2, you find a lot of neuro repairs. But do not use copper oxide, because copper links up with mercury and with potassium in the body of the man. It can create a different condition. It's not hazardous, but it's something you don't need. So you can clean metal toxicity from the body using the water of the gas. And if it's not enough, you just add a little bit more. Try to use, once you make the culture the base, use the culture base. Don't use to use it, use the water. Because it transferred the homogeneous energy to the water. And now you made the soap mixture with different dances. Just use it as base. You can use it for hundreds of years. Just put water on it and you collect the harvested water and use it. It has the same effect.
Yeah, Mr. Keshe, you mentioned a teaspoon or two. Does that mean that the patient have to drink it?
Just drink the water. Yeah. Yes, okay. Yes. Just the water, okay. Because now you have made the gas. Mix it, let it settle to the bottom, and use the water. And it works effectively. I tell you how effectively it works.
Thank you.
I tell you, you shared so much beautiful knowledge. You just let me share with you a little bit of knowledge for those who are with us.
Thank you. Thank you.
You know, we have shared, we are running a trial on using the gas and the gas water for what we call supplements for eye and for skin. You are using coconut and cocoa cream. We are using olive oil as this for the same purpose. For the eye drops, I'm using a CO2 water, not the gas of CO2. I explained this, you're not the first one to hear, but I explained this yesterday with the teaching with the doctors. It's well known around the people who know me, I suffer from degeneration of eye, which means I'm losing my sight slowly in different dimensions. And I even switched from a normal telephone to retina screens just to be able to read at least easier. Now that we have launched the GANS water for eye as an eye drop, I started using the eye drop water GANS in my eyes last Sunday. I explained this in the medical teaching yesterday. And I could not see, even reading the phone, I mean from the mobile phone, I had to concentrate, narrow my eyes that I could see the pictures. I changed the bigger screen in the past couple of weeks to be able to see more. And first time I used the eye drop in my eyes, I had a strange headache, a strange tingling feeling in the back of my brain. When I used it the second time, I had the tinkling on my tongue. It was very strange for about hours. But since literally the first day since Monday, I can see what I could not see before. This morning just become I come on the presentation. I was with Caroline in my office, and the table is there. The paper is about 2 meters away from me on the table and her. I said, Caroline, look, I can read the number. It's 16042016. She said, you can read from this distance now. I said, I don't know. Yeah. I can see the new world. I feel the pressure in my eye has changed. You know, your eyes narrows down and your facial pressure changes. Now I feel relaxation in my face, because I don't need to concentrate. Now I could not see at night. Yesterday, I see totally new, different world. So I'm testing the gas water directly into my own eyes, because I suffer badly. It's suffering when I go to sleep at night. I had a lot of pressure in my eyes all the time. This morning I woke up with no pressure. It was a pleasure to be young again. I can see I was sitting here, if you come in the auditorium, I was sitting on the second row. Many times in past year being here, I sit on these chairs while you lot teach, And I tried to look, I can't read. I know the book is there, is my books on the table. Now, from here, I can read the word, what they are. I'm about 5 meters, 10 meters away. I can read the books.
Wow.
And that's in 4 days of just spraying some gas water of the CO2 into my eye. Because if I deliver a technology, I have to be standing the test of the technology myself. So I see the difference. So you can try it. Try it safely. There are thousands of people with eye degeneration. It has worked on me. But as I said yesterday to the doctors, I'm not interested in me seeing better. What I'm interested in is why in changing the condition of my eye, the tongue nerves reacted. This is a strange point. What has the eyes got to do with the nerves of the tongue? Why my pain in the back of my head, where there is a section in regarding the writing, had a problem? I'm left-handed, I stopped writing because I can't see properly. Now it means when you adjust the eye, everything else in the body of the man, in the brain, which adjusted itself for your disability, which is coming up, now is recollecting itself too. You understand? Look at the implementation and what this technology brings, not just because you did the soap and it cleaned. Is not a orange juice or a skin of orange oil which makes it thinner. The technology is a transfer of the energy. Use these soaps and see how you can take the stains off. How do they affect the stain? Not only the bacterias. Do we transfer the energy? Do we need any water to wash anymore? Or can we put the soap near it and transfer the energy from it? You understand? This is what we have to extend the knowledge. We're opening a new door, and thanks very much to officers of. I always said, I was telling yesterday or last Friday to the people in the Italian nuclear center, I was the guest of them. Thanks to the officers of CIA who brought us to Ghana. We thank the American authorities for bringing us to Ghana to be able to do free research and development. It has brought beautiful people like you with your knowledge with us. We work with everyone. We have no boundaries and borders in sharing knowledge. And thanks to people who are around the foundation, knowing what we can do, now we can see the beauty of Africa and the knowledge of their scientists. It'll be nice to invite or to allow the other scientists to come to Ghana Space Institute, and as Benjamin said a few minutes ago, you have scientists from all over the world. We are there at the Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute Summit in August. I have left the time and the place in the hand of Benjamin. We will be glad to have, we have scientists all over Africa who work in different aspects of the Keshe Foundation to be there. It's time, and I said this many times, and as you know, as I said, I spent years in Africa. It's time that the scientists of Africa do not have to clean laboratories in America to pay to become doctors, to be kept for their knowledge back in America. I have many friends, doctors, professors, who did everything in US and Europe to become doctors and scientists, and then they kept out of their nation to the assets of where they clean the toilets with. Now it's time for the Europeans to come to Africa and learn knowledge from the birthplace. You have beautiful scientists. I have a lot of respect for doctors and professors and scientists in Africa, because you spent time deliberately and a lot of resources of the families which they don't have to become scientists where you sit here. And it's very different than somebody who's given a grant and everything on the table, you just go and read the book, we give you a degree. A lot of scientists like you, a lot of scientists we see in Iran nuclear industry, in atomic structures of the East Asia, you worked to become where you are. It wasn't given to you on a silver spoon. And for that, you learn the true science, and there is a lot of respect for you. I work with a lot of you. I have very good friends in different African nations over 30 years, 40 years. And this is time to change the position. Let the world come to Africa to learn from Africa how easily you can share knowledge unconditionally. Thank you very much for sharing knowledge with us today. Let us see what you bring us next week. What are you trying to show us?
Mr. Akesh, they are fighting over it. Who should I give? A car unit here, so...
Car unit? You stop your manufacturing company, and then you can share it with anybody you like. As you know, Ghana manufacturing, he's doing a lot of car units and home units and giving it to everybody. Half of the management of the Ghana New Atomic Center are living on free electricity. So we have to make it free for the whole of the nation. We're setting up the factory up very soon in Ghana to produce all these units. Benjamin works during the day in the center, and at night he makes units for everybody else. Thank you very much, Benjamin. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
For Atomic Energy. Thanks for sharing knowledge with us.
Thank you. We thank you, and because of our busy schedules, we want to still, you know, go and then do our work. A lot of them have left their offices for this program, so I would like to thank you for, you know, watching us and listening to us. We will do what Mr. Akesh has asked us to do, and then come and then present it again. Thank you all.
Thank you very much indeed. Thank you indeed for sharing knowledge. Thank you, Ghana. Is there, now you know that we have the agricultural at Keshe Foundation as kfssi.org. We start the teaching on Wednesday mornings, and we'll come headed by Dr. Gota from Kenya. So all the programs will come from Africa. If you have knowledge to share with us, how it can be used in agriculture, please come and share with us. If you're a doctor in Africa and you're listening, join us on Africa at Doctors at KFSSI to share knowledge with us how we can use this new technology as we do with other scientists and doctors around the world. It's important to share knowledge the way we do, because we have made it unconditional. And it is important to share knowledge we do, because if this program gives a knowledge to one man to save the life of one child by simple, what it was shown just in past few, let's say, hours by Ghanaian scientists, we have served the purpose of living. If we have managed to stop one person to suffer from salmonella or the other bacterial or viruses with a simple spoon of water which is produced the way you do, and you showed us so freely, it was worth establishing and going through all the process of setting up the Ghana and Keshe Foundation. I thank you for it. The knowledge is shared unconditionally. I would like to see if we challenge the scientists from MIT, we challenge the scientists from Cornell University, if the Cornell University scientists would like to come and share so openly their papers without being peer reviewed. Let the humanity peer review the paper than a few what I call crooks of the peer review structure. I think we'll make the soap, a lot of us around the world, and we'll give you our peer review in the next couple of weeks, thanking you for saving a lot of pain for us. Your paper has been peer reviewed, your presentation, and you passed with the first class. It's published, what you've shown by millions of people see it, where a peer review published will be read by a few handful of people who might benefit by it financially. Thank you very much, Ghana. Where do we have to go now, Rick? What's our next step?
Well, Mr. Keshe, that was a lovely presentation.
Hello. Are you there?
Yeah, I had to mute everyone. Someone left and all the lines went open there.
Okay.
It's good now. How are you doing? We're, what, 3.5 hours into it here. We can carry on.
Was one of the best teachings of the past 2.5 years.
Yes, it was very nice and it was a very clear teaching, I thought. It was, came through loud and clear.
In the coming weeks, Professor Zhu will bring Chinese scientists to share knowledge the same with us. As now that we have developed the structure within Chinese teaching, Chinese Keshe Foundations will come back into part of the main teaching, as we've seen today, to show and explain to us what they've learned and what they can share with us. Let me explain something to you which is very important. We announced that our Italian friends, as we are in Italy, is it all done? Are we ready? We can go? No problem. Okay. Now the Italian website manager tells me yes. We promised you two things. As of today, the €300 donation on the website for power unit becomes voluntary. If you want, when you buy a unit, to donate €300 to the foundation for what you've seen we do in Africa and other places around the world, all this has to be paid for, it's not free. You can donate the 300, but from today, the power generating units will reduce to €500, €499 per unit, plus taxes, plus shipping. On the other hand, if you are an Italian citizen, you have to have an Italian address and live in Italy, you can buy the Magraph systems using the following link. Would you like to put it on the screen, please? Do you have it, Rick?
No, I don't have that yet. Vince, do you have that perhaps? Okay. Or is it the, you're talking about the...
You click on your Zoom, it's been sent to you. Is you can go on the Keshe Foundation, italycashfoundation.com or .org, and download the bank papers from Deutsche Bank. Two pages, very simple. We announced the sale of the units for 10 years at €10. The arrangement is too much for the banks to carry, so we have come with a new arrangement which is much cheaper for the bank and for you. It'll be around €21.59 for 3 years. So, all you need to do, fill in the application form, which is 2 pages of it, supply your, what you call, code physical, and a copy of last payment wages you have, and the units will be delivered to you. When you receive the delivery units, you start paying €21.56. This is the application form, is on the website of the Keshe Foundation, and you start receiving the units. All the units will be delivered within 60 to 90 days. At the moment, our delivery time will be about 7 to 14 days, according to what the stock is running. This is on the Italian Keshe Foundation. You need to download the documents, pages. Can you access the documents, please? The blue clicks, yeah. If you click on that one, this is the form you have to fill in. And then there is another form, very simple forms. If you go to the other one, please. This is the, go further down, further please. It's very simple, just a few lines. It tells you €21.59, 36 installments, and that covers for the interest of the bank and the paper, which it shows. This covers for insurance or death or whatever part of it, that if you anything happens, your family is not burdened with the payment. This is part of the structure of legal law in Italy, and now you can see it on the left hand side. It's called Deutsche Bank, German banks supporting the development. In the next month or two, we'll extend this application to Germany, France, Spain, Portugal, and Netherlands. So after a couple of months, the same through Deutsche Bank, you can buy Maghreb units across Europe using the same cash foundations of yours, because now the Dutch, the German or Dutch cashfoundation.org, KFSSI is going up, the French is going up. So we use your home pages for you to be able to get units literally the first, once you fill in the application form, from the time we receive it, the bank confirms it, you will receive your units within the time allocated. And you will see the development. The delivery of the system has become. We are monitoring everything with security services in the background for any abuse or any kind of Mickey Mouse games which comes out of Italy and Belgium. Then there is a second part to it. From this you can do today. If you're Italian, you can buy your power unit literally free, it'll get delivered. Those three things, which is in Italian, submitted, approved, you will be receiving your unit. Which means you don't need to invest any money, but the saving you do, around what we see, how much is it you're saving? 64%? 64%, which, and Giovanni says more too because he's using it. If you got a solar system, you'll be producing more energy, and at the same time, these units are delivered to universities in Italy for them to evaluate for different applications. So you're working in different directions. Can we have the other one, the banking system? Is it on? The bank, the São Paulo bank. You haven't put that on? No. Okay. From it'll be added to the website, hopefully. It's a holiday today here in Italy, and Friday. From Thursday next week, you can go to the bank, which is called Bank Intesa San Paolo. Can I have the white screen, please? I write it down that you can go, you don't need to go on a website. You can go directly to the bank in Italy next week, by next Thursday or so. They are setting up their programs that all the branches have the knowledge, the information. The bank is called, I write it in black. Yes, you can do. But let me just do this. It's called Banca Intesa. This is the number one bank in Italy. Intesa San Paolo. They have 6,000 branches. All branches have to be informed that this contract has been or can be used. So if you go there, they say they don't know, it means you have to wait till they get it. You use the convention of the company, which is part of the cash foundation structure, Aqua and Sole, cash foundation, you fill in the form in Banca Intesa San Paolo, Convention Aqua Sole Cash Foundation, and you receive, once the bank approves your application, you receive your units. You are then obliged to go if you're a, what do you call it, a customer of the bank. There are 6,000 branches in Italy. About 600 of them in the next 2 months, 3 months will have a stand inside the bank that you can just go to the stand and fill in the form. If you're a customer, you automatically sign into and receive your units. And in cities like Milan and north of Italy, you will see the advertising on the public billboards. There will be 700 bank offices who are allocated by the bank to sell the units in Italy. We expect to produce up to 2 million this year, next 12 months. We've been told the target, our target will be about 9 million in the first 2 years. And we are targeting and setting up in that direction. So if you go to Banca Intesa San Paolo, from the 9th, we've been told 9th, 10th, it should be already, all the programs should be in the computers. Convention, Aqua and Sole, Cash Foundation, you will receive the units. We are informed that the application is accepted. All you do, you get a knock on the door from the postman, your unit is delivered. It's like the bird which brings the baby. So, would you like to go through the Deutsche Bank? It's the same as with the Banco Sole. It could be a slight difference. We're trying to arrange that to be at about 1999, but it all depends how we arrange it with the bank. We can do different things with it, but it's around 21 instead of 10 years is for 36 months. In the next couple of weeks, we might add an addition where you pay very small amount, but on a life contract, which means you pay a small amount to the foundation and we give you a unit, and as you save 50-60% of your energy saving, the contract stays for 30-40 years, as long as you live or you can pass on the unit. That this allows the foundation to support its research. That is not done to sell. We don't sell the unit. We give you a unit, the money you save, the small amount you put back in the foundation for years to support other researchers. This is a factoring company which will be owned by the Cash Foundation. As we said, we are going into the banking system. It's our own banking system, a factoring company which support this. This takes us another few weeks, we'll be in that position. We have received backing of governments, of banking world, and the scientific world, and we share it with what comes to us. Italy is a flagship for the Cash Foundation. A lot of you, as I was explaining to Sylvester yesterday, you stood by the foundation. You accepted the first Maghreb units. A slightly different, torn application forms, boxes not being intact, but you kept to the ethos of the foundation there to help humanity and for us to learn. And now the benefit of what you trust in us goes back to humanity. We're delivering units across the world. We had delays because it's a teething of a new science and a new technology. And thanks to a lot of you standing by us, by the foundation, by the rest of us, we have come through to maturity. Those of you who approached us for baking companies, manufacturing, in a very short time, as I announced before, we release container manufacturing. So it means if you want to produce, let's say, the soap production from Ghana, Ghana will receive benefits from the sale of the units because they brought the knowledge on the table, but we deliver a full factory in a container to you. So all you need to do, assemble what comes out of the container, you have yourself a soap factory, and you can sell and produce material the way it supports your nation or your culture. This way, you've seen the foundation is going very rapidly into what we said, the freedom we're given. And as I said before, we thank the Italian government for allowing the Cash Foundation to grow in Italy, and we are feeding back into the nation and to the rest of the world for it. Any other thing? Now, You can go as Italians and place your order on the application form or on the banking system. You can go if you make a combination of new materials which is coming up by the Quechua nation, has to be above 600 euro, like the new energizers which we're putting out, the heating system which we are putting out, and use of the health programs of the Quechua nation. You still go to the bank, you can take the same procedure and you receive all the materials. But the minimum order has to be at 650 euro, and the materials systems will be in position next few weeks or months, that you can make your order from the basket of the orders of the Keshe Foundation on the website. Any other news? Anything else you would like to share?
There was a suggestion from Rodula in the live stream that may I suggest the Keshe Foundation to prepare a short presentation for plasma technology and applications in health, so that we can inform doctors who may be interested. Thanks.
Excuse me, this goes to a man who's in charge of it. Dr. Klaus, would you like to tell us if he can do it?
Yes, of course, we need any information from you, but please contact us first on the doctors@keshefoundation.org, and then we'll get in touch with the doctors, and we'll get in touch with you, and so we can find the solutions.
In a way, they want a video that could be made by you or the doctors you have on your team to show what, explain in the doctor's language what it is, that on the link which you provide, the doctor just can click it and listen to it. That's more or less what I think they're asking, that the more doctors can become aware of the use.
Yes, you know, we are working on a kind of summary of the different cases you're going through. Yeah. And the different therapies you suggest to the doctors. So this summary, this handbook, like we call it, would also be a way to publish these different cures, these different therapies you offer the doctors in the medical teaching.
Thank you very much. If we can produce something like a small video as they're asking, I think it's a very good idea, that doctors can see simply some of the tools you use or the doctors use.
And yes.
That mm-hmm. would be, the picture speaks a thousand words, as they say.
Yes, so we could implement these pictures after the doctors use it in their surgeries, and we could put these pictures also into the handbook or publish it separately then.
That's perfect. Thank you very much. Any other suggestions? Can we have Dr. Gota? Is Dr. Gota from Kenya online? Now he's heading the Keshe Foundation Agriculture. Would you like to add anything with what you started?
I believe he is here. Hello?
Yes, I'm online. Dr. Keshe, how are you?
Thank you very much. Doctor, it's your floor. You are the heading it. Tell us what terms you want to put on your teaching.
Thank you very much for your new announcement. And Ghana, this teaching from Ghana was excellent. And I'm ready to start teaching agriculture as from next week on Wednesday, according to how it will be planned. Right now, I'm back in Kenya from the USA, where I'm testing seed germination using CO2 guns, water, and their early growth. I'm also going to test other crops, like in the field, and I'm preparing the field right now. It's almost ready. So new crops will be going in, and we'll all learn from it. Thank you very much. I don't have a lot to add now, but what I have will be in the next week's teaching. Thank you very much for giving me this opportunity to teach agriculture.
Thank you very much indeed. If you are involved in agriculture, we've seen from South America, we've seen from Australia and the Chinese, please join us in this process. We learn from you if you've tested anything, or you can learn from us. We haven't put any criteria on who can join, who can't, but we try to find a parameter that is to the agriculturist, to the farming community. And with this, we'll bring in, as part of the agriculture, the veterinarian as well. Because it's not just growing the food, it's looking after nurturing the animals on the field as well. So we try with Dr. Gutta to bring and give platform, if you're a veterinarian, if you're involved with the healthcare of the animals, to become part of the teaching as part of the agriculture and a veterinarian. That because more or less you will learn what you use for your animal, you can use for your plants with the same benefit. So it's a mutual replication of the science. Anything else, or shall we call it a day?
Mr. Keshe, just a question, because some veterinarians also applied for the medical teaching. Shall we then let them switch to the agricultural teaching?
Human body and animal body is the same, they can go to both.
Okay.
Because we know Dr. Rodriguez treats dogs as good as women and men and children.
Yes. And we
showed us a dog with a tumor.
Yeah, and we just got in a picture from a dog which was injured in his eye, came in touch with chemicals, and after 1 week by using the liquid plasma CO2 in his eye, it was nearly gone. So it's amazing.
You see that. Strange enough is doctors are human too, and they get sick. They get injured, and it's good to see if they can't find a solution in their world, they'll come to the plasma world and find a solution for it. And as I said, it's beautiful for me and you. It's hard to explain. I'm more or less 10-20 meters away from the table. I can read the words on the book I wrote 7-8 years ago, because I could not see. So to me, it works. Irrespective of whatever they say, the pressure has gone and life looks different. It's very beautiful. Thank you very much for sharing knowledge with us. I thank the scientists in Ghana Space Institute, the Ghana Atomic Commission, and thanks for all the other scientists who shared knowledge with us. I hope you learned today what we already knew as a soap scientist, as what I call the GANS makers, that you can use the technology to create as much crystals and as much solid material you like, now that you have learned how to crawl. It's time for the man to walk into the space with his head high. Thank you very much today. We'll see you hopefully next week. Thank you very much.
Great, thank you very much, Mr. Keshe.
If you like to play the last two videos as us going, it'll be fantastic.
Before that, Sis Flint, I would like to just make an announcement here. Upcoming here at 2 p.m. Central European Time is the question and answer session for the private teachings. So, all of us.
Thank you very much.
And teachers.
You can join the teachings of the plasma technology on kfssi.org. You can enroll, and the tuition fee is 100 euro a year. If you are from a country or a nation in Africa or South America which cannot pay the 100 euro, you get a free entrance. Thank you very much indeed. Thanks for your time.
Okay, thanks very much, Mr. Keshe. Vince, can you get that video lined up? Okay, excellent. I'll just make the announcement now, and then we'll phase out with the video, that this was the 116th Knowledge Seekers Workshop for June 2nd, 2016. Thank you, everybody, for attending. Wonderful workshop. And happy birthday, Vince.
Happy birthday, Rick.
Thank you. All right. So let's move into the video.
Thank you very much.
The Universal Council invites you to attend the One Planet, One Nation, One Race event in Rome on the 9th and 10th of September 2016. The Council looks forward to open interaction with the public at the event. Come interact with the Council in your spoken language. The Council encourages you to bring your positive suggestions and solutions to the table on how humanity can move forward as a whole towards everlasting peace. In this way, the work of the members of the Council will become the work of humanity for humanity. The full package price for a single ticket to the event includes 3-night stay in one of Rome's prestigious hotels, daily attendance to the event, as well as breakfast on the 9th through the 11th, and lunch and tea on the 9th and 10th. Accommodations for this package is based on double occupancy. The full package price for 2 tickets to the event includes 3-night stay in a twin bed room in one of Rome's prestigious hotels, daily attendance to the event, as well as breakfast on the 9th through the 11th, and lunch and tea on the 9th and 10th. Additional night stay are offered at €150 per person per night. For those who wish to arrange their own accommodations and who plan on attending a single day of the event, the cost will be €200, which includes tea and lunch on the day of the event. For those who wish to arrange their own accommodations and who plan on attending both days of the event, the cost will be €400, which includes tea and lunch on the day of the event. The One Planet, One Nation, One Race event in Rome. Come share your positive solutions on how we can work together to bring everlasting peace to our world. Would you like to be one of the first humans in space using plasma technology? The Keshe Foundation Spaceship Institute is now taking applications for the Man-Originated Zone Habitation and Nutrition Training Program, or MOZON. The goal of MOZON is to teach trainees how to create and utilize the magnetically oriented joint habitation and nutrition system that will be used for life in space. Be one of the first humans in space using plasma technology. The 3-month MOZON training program begins in the fall of 2016. Apply today at mozon.kfssi.org. Trainees will be taught every aspect of plasma technology needed for them to go to space and survive, and will be educated in space ethos. Participants are expected to bring the knowledge forward to the peoples of their nations to prepare them to become peoples of space. Matter propulsion technology. Today on Earth, we use inefficient and costly rocket propulsion technology, which burns fuels to overcome the magnetic gravitational fields of the planet to go to space. We power our rockets, our cars, and our homes by burning matter to release the energy that we convert from one form to another in order to create motion and usable energy. As well, to achieve objectives, rockets, for example, have to carry large and heavy payloads of fuel, which means that they're payload dependent. Matter propulsion technology is very destructive, inefficient, polluting, and wasteful. Now, let's look at the new alternative, matter gravitational technology. Matter gravitational technology uses the properties of the entirety of plasma to create motion, lift, and energy without destroying the characteristics of matter. The system utilizes magnetic and gravitational field interaction to attain positioning and motion. Nothing is burned, there's no waste, and no pollution is created. Matter gravitational technology is efficient and not destructive. Current human scientific achievement is the result of a progressive evolution in science and technology over thousands of years. Plasma technology is the next step in that evolution. It's viable, and it's here today. You could be one of the first humans in space using plasma technology. Apply today to the MOSAN training program.